out.
We'll start in 2:20. We'll start at 23 on the clock. Minute and a half. We'll start in 1 minute. 1 minute. We'll do an intro for probably a minute and a half, 2 minutes. I'll take a minute break, and then we'll do coach interviews. Good evening to you, and welcome here to the Great Western Hyper, Kelvin Sampson Court, the NAIA Men's National Championship Tournament. We are down to 32 teams, and after today, we'll be down to 16 as the round of, the second round of the tournament underway here in the Mining City as Montana Tech, the number 3 seed out of the Naismith Quadrant, taking on Lewis Clark State, who comes in as the 11th seed out of the Naismith Quadrant. Paul Panisco, John Thatcher, Saturday evening. JT, how are you?
I'm good. I'm always anxious for this, and season begins here, and it's real important you get out of here to get to the big dance. Everybody's journey is to get that big first place trophy.
You know, we talked an awful lot yesterday about energy, about nerves, things like that. Is all that stuff kind of put to bed, or does it get worse for the second round?
No, I don't think it gets worse. I think the intensity is probably going to be great, but the nerves are gone, and you're going to find guys that they're great competitors come out here and get after it. You always worry about that first one because you know you can't lose that one. You just know it. You're going home, and so nerves interact with you. But now they know what they're playing for, and they're ready to go, both teams.
Well, again, thanks for joining us here as we make our way through the day here on Digger Vision in Butte, Montana, and we welcome all our friends listening down to Lewiston, Idaho, as well, and around the country as we make our way through this Saturday afternoon as Montana Tech taking on the Warriors of Lewis Clark State. We talked about it a lot yesterday. Lewis Clark State, of course, a former Frontier Conference member. They were in the Frontier Conference for 22 years. They won the regular season crown 8 times in those 22 years, and they won the tournament 9 times. And they certainly made our conference a heck of a lot better while they were part of it. We'll talk about that more, but we're going to check in with our coaches as Coach Adam Hyatt and Coach Johnson here in just a moment. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll take a break. We are back here to the Hyper after this 1 minute timeout.
Now's the time to get into Butte Auto and custom build your own ride just the way you want it. Choose from 9 brands and compare them all at one location. Don't wait. Take advantage of our VIP appointment or stay where you are and shop easily from ButteAuto.com. At Butte Auto, we believe in exceptional service and an easy buying process. Easy buying process. Contact one of our 4 dealerships and custom build your next ride at Butte Auto today.
Trident 5550, the Case IH combination application system solution. A couple of key points for model year 2024 are going to be the addition of 135-foot spray boom for that enhanced productivity, and then AIM Command Flex 2, the ultimate in advanced spray technology, individual on-off nozzle control, a host of other features, making the most of your product application. To learn more, visit your Case IH distributor or caseih.com.
Welcome back here to the campus of Montana Tech, round 2 of the NAI National Tournament. John Thatcher and I were talking, Coach. First off, congratulations. Huge win last night to advance to the second round. You always worry about energy and nerves, things like that. Yep. Is it easier for round 2, or does it amplify for round 2?
Well, a little bit of both. It amplifies because the stakes are higher. But at the same time, though, getting that one game under your belt, going into round 2, especially on your home floor, it relaxes you a little bit. Get you calmed down. You know, when you're not able to play for 2 weeks, there's a little bit of nervous energy. I didn't think that we played with the best of rhythm last night, so we're expecting a little bit better game tonight in terms of rhythm.
You know, one thing that we talked about with LC last night is they had a game earlier in the year with Hope International, and you find yourself in that same mold
But again, it's months ago. I mean, probably you consider yourself a much different team now than when you played them the first time. How much weight and how much pressure do you put on yourself looking at that film from the first game, and how do you go about that?
Yeah, we never even looked at it. I mean, it's too long ago. They're a completely different team. They were trying to figure out who they were playing. They had a lot of different players that played in that game that aren't even here. And so they're a much better team now. They have their rotation established. They have great shooting, great guys that drive and distribute, great post play. They are a terrific team. They finished second outright in the Cascade. We respect them like nobody else because they're a former Frontier member. We know how good they are. Their coach is outstanding. So we know we're going to have our hands full. And we also, at the same time, we're a different team as well.
Yeah, big time.
You know, so we're a little bit, we hope that we're better than what we were back then, but it's going to be a tremendous battle tonight.
You know, I was stepped in the gym just for a few moments when you guys are practicing today. Intensity felt really high. It felt like the game faces were on, if you use that expression.
Yeah, they were. Our guys know what's at stake. There's nothing guaranteed in this business. Anything can happen in a 40-minute game. But I was happy with our preparation today. I think that we're going to have a great effort.
All right, Coach Hyatt, thank you much. Let's roll. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll get Coach Johnson, and we'll check in with the Lewis-Clark stateside in just a moment. Hey, welcome back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech. Coach Johnson from Lewis-Clark State. Congratulations. Great win in week one, or I guess in round one yesterday. Talk about your energy coming in for round two.
We'll see if we got some left. But no, our guys are excited. Last night was a big win. Any win in the national tournament is a big win. And it's going to be awesome. It's a true road game to go to the Sweet 16. So that's an awesome opportunity for our guys, and I think our guys are excited.
You know, you find yourself in an interesting situation where you played Hope International earlier in the year, you played Montana Tech earlier in the year. Talk about how much you even look at that film. I mean, those games are, you know, 3 and 4 months ago, it seems like. Do you benefit at all in any situation like that?
Not a ton. You know, they didn't have Belich. We didn't have all of our guys. Yeah. They're a different team since then, and I think we're a different team since then as well. So, I mean, there's a couple things you look at, but honestly, for the most part, it's a whole new scout, whole new game.
You know, from a Frontier fan, I love to have you back in the building. I mean, you know, Lewis-Clark State made this conference better.
Yep.
And it's great to have you on the floor anytime we can.
We had some awesome battles, and they love their basketball in Montana. That's one thing about the Frontier, so we're excited for tonight.
Well, and talk about the energy. I mean, if you guys stuck around, you saw the crowd, how it went last night.
Yep.
You're used to playing in front of big crowds. I mean, I would assume that Lewis-Clark State, one of the most highly attended programs in the country. Talk about how you fight through that kind of noise.
Yeah, we've played in front of great crowds at home, at College of Idaho, at Oregon Tech, and so again, the focus we always say is internal, not external, and so the crowd becomes an issue if you let it become an issue with your play, and you know, if we take quick shots or if we turn it over, the crowd's going to get loud because they're going to be dunking on the other end. So for us, focus on ourselves. That's kind of been the whole message, and the crowd's going to be there, but they're not going to be guarding us or, you know, all those things. So try and limit it as much as we can.
All right, Coach, we'll let you go. Thank you for your time. Appreciate it. Coach Johnson from Lewis-Clark State, ladies and gentlemen. We'll take a break. We'll get back with JT right after this.
We really wanted to expand our menu, really wanted to expand our clientele, offer the full bar, offer the grill and pub menu. I think everybody at First Montana did a really good job just walking us through it and explaining everything. Ryan really helps us by asking us personal questions. It makes a personal investment in what we're doing here. I think that matters more than just about anything, really. The personal relationship that you have and the personal attention that you get.
First Montana Bank. Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
I think there's more than one thing that makes Montana Tech unique.
I think it's incredible. It's special.
I've always kind of thrived off the adventure side of things and the unknown. There's no place I'd rather be going to school.
Montana Tech has provided me more than I ever could have expected.
Montana Tech made me a trailblazer.
Montana Tech made me a healer.
Montana Tech is my solution.
Be the solution. Visit Montana Tech today.
Hey, welcome back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech. Kelvin Sampson courts as Montana Tech taking on the Warriors of Lewis Clark State College. As we get a little Frontier rematch. This makes me so happy. It makes me so happy I can't even tell you, JT.
I'm a coach that's usually relaxed before a game, so I don't get as excited. I like to see you excited. I can't do that.
I'm calling Bravo Sierra on that. You were kind of bouncing around. You have a little more loose energy today than you normally do.
Oh, because it's the big one. It's the one that gets you to the main dance. Yeah, I mean, I like that. No question about it.
You know, these two teams obviously played an awful lot through those years in the Frontier Conference, and looking forward to this one here tonight as Montana Tech taking on the Warriors of Lewis Clark State College. Let's start things off. Let's start with the home team as Montana Tech is coming off a great win yesterday over Wayland Baptist, who were so far removed from being a 14 seed. It's almost laughable. But talk about what you liked about what Montana Tech did yesterday.
Well, I liked it. We talked about runs in that game, and they had the one that counted. But I liked how they maintained their composure. Because to be quite honest with you, last night was the night they could have been beaten. Mm-hmm. They held their composure, played great defense, and got the things done that you need to win. And their bench was not as good as it has been all during the season. And, of course, the other team has a lot to do with that because they were good. They were good on defense. They were quick. And they need Michael Uhr to come out, step up this game. They need his scoring. They're not going to get out of here with 73 or 74 points tonight. They got to put the ball through the hole, and more people got to score. You can't fall on two bodies all the time, Belich and Williams. You've got to get some other people entertained, and they've got people off the bench that can come up, pick them up, get them some big points. So we'll see.
You know, you look at the other side of the Warriors out of Lewis Clark State. We talked about it a bunch early. You know, they're coming in here with a short bench, only nine guys on their traveling roster. Eight of those scored, and what are we looking at? One, two, three, four, five of those eight were in double digits. I thought the Warriors were outstanding yesterday, and it was such a weird game of like ebb and flow because Hope International controlled the first 8 minutes of the first half, and they controlled the first 8 minutes of the second half, and then LC just rolled them over the final 12 minutes of both the first and the second half.
Yeah, they certainly did. And, you know, I like this LC team. I think the advantage right here in this game right now, Montana Tech's guards. They got more guards. And Stockton's had a great game last night. Can he continue? That's the question. These two teams match up really, really well. And I look for a great basketball game.
Yeah, I'm kind of with you. I think they do match up awfully well. Oh, yeah. You know, you look at Jaden Bradley. The senior had 21 points yesterday. He was a monster. 4 3-pointers. That was perfect from the foul line. That right there might be the biggest difference. I think I'm okay now. The biggest difference between these two teams from yesterday, LC was phenomenal from the free throw line. And Montana Tech was atrocious from the foul line. And Coach Adam Hyatt would be the first one to tell you that. They ended up at 55% from the foul line. At this level of game, when you're in the national tournament, you had better make your free throws. And last night was not their night from the foul line.
Absolutely not. You and I had talked about that. And in the first game,
Hope International.
Hope International, they made like 517 free throws during the season. Shot one in the first half or two, and then got a break, got a technical, got to shoot two more. But once they started going attacking the basket, they made their free throws. Yes. But they had dug such a deep hole, there's no way they were coming out of it. It wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, and LC, as I look at my notes, LC didn't miss a free throw in the first half. They were, it looks like, 7 of 7 in the second half. They missed 4 of, I'm guessing, about 18. I mean, they were just phenomenal from the foul line.
Yeah, you'll take that any day of the week.
I'm excited for the defensive side of this one. You know, you look at both these teams, and we certainly know that Coach Adam Hyatt, if you're going to get on the floor, you're going to play defense. If you don't play defense for him, you're not going to play. And the defense that LC put up yesterday was fantastic as well, and I'm really excited to see the chess match between two really defensive-driven coaches.
Well, they've already watched film. They know what they're looking for. They know who they got to stop, and sometimes scorers are going to score, so you stop everybody else. We'll see what kind of philosophy they came out with. This is not going to be a post-oriented game per se like we got last night. This is not a power game. And the other thing is, both teams are going to shoot the three. It depends on how well they shoot them. And that's how important it is. Michael Jura's got to find out right away in the game whether he can get a step or get a three at the top of the key on ball reversal. I'm really interested in that matchup because I think he is the key to Montana Tech today.
Okay. Well, again, thanks for joining us here on Digger Vision as we make our way through this. Just a great day here in the Mining City is what I'm told. I haven't been outside since like 8 o'clock this morning, but I'll take everybody's word for it. We are getting ready for the tip-off of this one. Second round of the NAIA National Tournament for our friends in Lewiston. The women starts in about 40 minutes, and I believe that one is being streamed online. So, again, that's the Warriors are in a great position. Their men's program is in the second round. Their women's program is in the second round, and certainly a good day for them. But it sounds like we're live on the airwaves down there, and the girls' game, the women's game, rather, is being streamed. I think that's what I was told. So there you go.
I'll go watch it.
Okay. So, ladies and gentlemen, again, thanks for joining us here on a Saturday. We're at Digger Vision at Montana Tech. Paul Panisco, John Thatcher. Let's take a break. We'll come back. We'll talk about players, talk about these teams a little bit more right after this 1 minute timeout.
Branding with a company like Butte Auto that shares our mission of community partnership, making the Butte community a better place to be while being excellent in their field, is a natural partnership that we're excited to be a part of.
Hey, Dave Brennan here with Case IH. One of the new options for model year 2024 is going to be an open spoke gauge wheel. That open spoke gauge wheel is going to be available on all 2000 series planters. That's going to help those growers in adverse conditions where they're muddy or high residue conditions minimize that plugging in and around that gauge wheel area. For more information on this new offering of open spoke gauge wheels, visit your local Case IH dealer.
Hey, once again, welcome back here to the campus of Montana Tech. Ordinger basketball here on Digger Vision. Second round of the NAIA National Tournament. Back-to-back years for Montana Tech hosting the first and second rounds here in Butte, Montana. And they'll look to try and keep their streak alive. And the same thing is get two wins at home and move off to Kansas City. Of course, the winner of this ball game will get the pass to head off to Kansas City and join the other 15 programs and try and fight them for that red banner.
That's the ultimate goal, get to the big dance. You can't do that if you don't walk out of here, so you don't even think about the big dance. You think about this game and this game only.
You know, it's interesting, the idea of the quick turnaround and scouting teams and the difference for both of these teams, their opponents are staggeringly different than the team they played yesterday. You know, and as I sit here and kind of analyze that, I think of, you know, Hope International. The one thing that is similar between the two programs is Montana Tech's defense is going to get after them. But I think Montana Tech, if I'm looking at it from the perspective of Lewis Clark State, I think Montana Tech is going to shoot the ball, light years better than Hope International does across the board. You know, you're not trying to stop one or two guys because Montana Tech is going to be able to score, not only the starting five, but another five or six deep. That's going to be a big adjustment for the Warriors of LCC.
Well, that was the point I was going to bring up. Montana Tech can go down deep in their bench. Lewis and Clark doesn't have a bench, to be quite honest with you. They got four guys over there, and I don't know the ones who didn't come for whatever reason, how vital were they? So bench is real important in this basketball game. But the bench guys got to come out and do a better job than they did yesterday. They have to.
Let's talk about the other factor in this. Obviously, Lewiston isn't they're gaining some elevation. We talked about it a lot yesterday, and the fact that, you know, they might not feel the gas in the gas tank, you know, in the first game, but you thought they might be more affected by the altitude in day two.
Yeah, well, you've used your legs already for one day, and now your lungs are going to come into play, and it always happens about second quarter, second half. You know what? They're young kids. They can survive, and I don't think altitude's an issue right now. They're so pumped up, full of adrenaline, they're ready to get out and go.
When I look at this Montana Tech team preparing for this Lewis Clark State team as opposed to Wayland Baptist yesterday, I almost feel like they're preparing more for themselves than a different team. This LC team, really unselfish. They distributed the basketball exceptionally well. They made great decisions with the basketball. And it almost feels like a little bit of a mirror match in a lot of ways with these two teams.
Yeah, you know, it's different styles. They're playing, they're not playing as guard as quick as they did yesterday. Mm-hmm. They're not. It's just totally different styles. So you and I are going to have to get a feel in the first 2 to 3 minutes for what exactly their game plan is. Is it to get inside? Is it to get somebody off? See if you can get somebody on your team to score early. Are you going to push the ball, which I expect both of these teams to do, although I really like the both teams. If they don't have what they want on a break, they get out and run their stuff. So I don't know. I got to see philosophy taking place. What are you looking for in this game, and you can't find that except first 2 or 3 minutes.
So you've already brought up the idea that Michael Uhr, would you consider him the X factor in this one? If Montana Tech is to win, Michael Uhr is the person that has to make it happen?
Well, not make it happen. This is team basketball. I mean, there's 10 guys over there that can make it happen. I think he's got to be effective. Okay. He's got to be more effective than he was yesterday. Got two quick fouls, got himself frustrated. Had to deal with a much stronger post player. He's got a tall one today, but not with the bulk that the post player had yesterday. But he did not kick it into his A game because he was taken out of his game. And I think the two fouls hurt him more mentally than anything. And then
agreed.
He tweaked his ankle a little bit for a minute. So he was having a bad hair night. Let's just say that.
You know, and that kind of plays into the other side of this coin for me is I look at Alton Hamilton, the young freshman. I thought he played awfully well yesterday, as did Jaden Bradley. And I'm interested to see who they put on who here, because if Bradley is on Uhr, I think that is a really fun matchup to watch. But if they put Bradley on Uhr, I'm interested to see what they do with Hayden Deacons. I really feel like, and we've said this all year long, but I really feel like Hayden Deacons is going to be the real question mark. I think he is going to be the one that everybody's going to have to watch out for. And I almost feel like LC has seen him before, so that helps. But he is the guy that creates mismatch issues and really makes life difficult on the other team.
I don't question that one bit. He's the best defense player on this Tech team, no question about it. And he's tough to guard because of his athleticism. His weakness is he doesn't shoot the three very often, if at all. And they'll back off him because he loves penetration. And he loves going to his left, and he likes getting to the bucket. So we'll see if they've watched enough film to determine, just leave him out there. And if he hits a couple, then we got to go guard him. If he doesn't, let him shoot it. But I'll tell you this, he won't shoot it. He'll reverse the ball like any smart player will do and get back in where he belongs to attack in the basket.
Well, as we sit here and talk, the Wayland Baptist guys are coming into the gym. They'll sit and watch, and we will see what happens with this one. As Montana Tech take it on the Warriors of Lewis Clark States, we'll have our starters here in a few. We're going to hear from our chief executive as well. But thanks for joining us. The second round of the NAIA National Tournament as Montana Tech take it on the Warriors of Lewis Clark States. If memory serves correct, I want to say if it wasn't the last year that Lewis Clark State was a Frontier Conference member, it might have been the second to last year, but that was one of the real rubbed-me-wrong years where LC and Carroll played each other in the semifinals. Do you remember that?
I don't.
It assured that we had a Frontier Conference member in the championship, but, boy, it would have been awfully good because those two were so powerful that year.
Yeah, they were. I do remember that now.
Well, again, thanks for joining us here. As the team's getting ready to line up, we'll get our national anthem, and from there, we will take a look at our starters, and I want to thank our crew for making this thing possible, as Barrett and company really doing an outstanding job here with Digger Vision, and we'll see what we get here. As we are going to pause for our national anthem, and again, we'll hear from our chief executive as J.P. Gallagher will come out and address this crowd. If you're not from the Butte area, if you're unfamiliar with what we've got going on, it's St. Urho's Day. It's the day before St. Patrick's Day. And Uptown Butte is already
an absolute madhouse. I went over the KC, yes.
Holy man. When I came uptown at like 9 o'clock this morning, there was already a madhouse.
And it's going to last till Monday.
Yes, that it will. So we got the guys coming out. We're going to get our national anthem. So with that, we will pause. We're back here to the Hyper, ladies and gentlemen, after this 2-minute timeout. We'll be right back.
It's more of a business anymore than it is riding. I'm booking, you know, travel, I'm booking athletes, large contracts, insurance, all kinds of different things. Ryan Nielsen, it doesn't get any better. I'm traveling busy all the time and he'll help with all kinds of different things, from being in touch with my accountant to help finance some of the stuff that I need to get everything taken care of. The relationship there is, it's absolutely amazing.
First, Montana Bank. Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Hey, welcome back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech as our chief executive, J.P. Gallagher, expressing to the crowd, talking about St. Patrick's Day and the meaning of it. We have a great crowd on hand here today, J.T.
Yeah, nice crowd. It's election year. Got to have our chief executive getting his kicks in.
All right, so let's get our starting lineups here, ladies and gentlemen. We'll start things off for the Warriors out of Lewis-Clark State. And again, thanks for joining us here as we make our way through it. The screen here, you see our starting five. Jaden Bradley is an outstanding player, averaging 15 a game. Newcomer of the year in the Cascade Conference. Davian Brown at guard had a great day yesterday. He did a tremendous job really controlling the tempo of this ball game. Alton Hamilton, the freshman, he was the freshman of the year in the Cascade Conference. I thought he had a great game yesterday. John Lustig starting as well. Lustig, a 6'4" sophomore. He was your guy yesterday in Lustig. And last but not least is Sam Stockton. Stockton is a senior, 6'2", wears number 10. And now as we go to the other side of the coin, Montana Tech will get our introductions here on the floor. So, again, we have a packed house here as Montana Tech getting ready to take on the Warriors out of Lewis-Clark State College. And let's get running down through the starters. Aza Williams is the first out. Aza, 6'6", senior, averages 16 a game, had a great day yesterday. He wears number one, and he is certainly the heartbeat of this basketball team. Krishan Dixon is starting at point. Krishan, the senior, out of Billings. Krishan, a 6'3", 6 foot senior, rather, getting the starting nod. Then we have Caleb Belich. Belly, the 6'7" senior, wears number 10, averages 13 points a game for Montana Tech, as he was first team all conference, as was Aza Williams. Hayden Decons, the defensive player of the year in the Frontier Conference. He was also honorable mention Frontier Conference. Hayden averaging 11.7 rebounds a game. He's a 6'6" sophomore. And last but not least, Michael Yore. Big Mike, a 6'7" junior. As you mentioned, quiet day yesterday. Mike averaging 13 a game, 6 rebounds as well. One of the best three-point shooters in the conference, right below 40%. And we'll look to get some Mike rolling here tonight.
Yeah, Mike's kind of the key. We'll see. They've got to distribute the ball. Tech needs more scoring out of more people. They didn't get enough of that. They won. They didn't get enough of that from everybody. That's why you play team basketball. Get everybody involved.
Lewis-Clark State is wearing their baby blues. Montana Tech with the home whites. And we are ready to roll. Montana Tech, the number 3 seed out of the Naismith bracket. Lewis Clark State College, the number 11 seed. Again, these two teams met a long, long time ago, back in November on this floor. Montana Tech won handily. And, of course, both coaches certainly were the first to say that was a lifetime ago. Krishan Dixon down the right side, comes up top to Michael Yor. Yor with the left hand, going to drive into the paint, spins to his right, puts up the shot, no good, but he draws the foul immediately.
Well, they left the floor open for him. They had to watch film. You had to know what he likes to do. You got to back off him far enough where he can't do all that. And that's a good first edition for Montana Tech here.
Well, I'll tell you, if they get... If Jaden Bradley gets into foul trouble early, that is going to change the look of this LC State team. Michael Yor at the line, knocks down his first. He's a 71% free throw shooter on the year. He has a huge contingent here for him this weekend. And Yor goes 2-of-2 from the foul line. Montana Tech leading 2-0 here in the opening moments. Stockton into the offensive zone, hands it off to Brown. Davian Brown, 13 points a game, back to Stockton on the baseline. Aza Williams on him defensively. Stockton will hand it off far left wing. Driving, nice take to the basket. Shot rattles in after bouncing four times for Bradley. So Bradley gets the first field goal of the contest, and Montana Tech the other way. Aza Williams, left hand around a screen, kicks it back to Yor. He eyed the three. Yor drives to the rack, no good. It's tipped out high. Stockton gets it. He'll move it down the floor right side to Bradley. Warriors, chance to grab the lead here in the opening moments. Bradley drives into the key to his left side. Ball stripped away. Now a late whistle and a foul. Krishan Dixon got a piece of him, or multiple pieces of him.
Yeah, he read he had a short on him. He's going to the basket, nowhere else, and that's good basketball.
So that puts Bradley at the line. Again, Bradley had a really nice day yesterday. Finished with 21 points. He was a perfect 7-of-7 from the foul line, and he gets his first one here. Warriors leading 3-2 here in the opening moments.
Yeah, when you switch defense on that perimeter and you get a small on a big, that big knows exactly where he's going with the basketball.
Bradley goes 2-of-2 from the foul line. And his 4 points leads Montana Tech 4-2. So Deacons, Belich cuts down to the baseline. Deacons hands it off to Williams. Williams around a screen, back up top to Yor. Michael Yor to Deacons into the key, steps through. Deacons with a right hand, floats it in. Hayden Deacons does what it feels like only Hayden Deacons can do.
Nice crossover. That's exactly what his game is, attack the rim.
90 seconds gone here in this first half. Second round of the NAIA National Tournament. LC State 4 wide. Hand off near side to Brown. Brown outside the arc, switch to the right hand, drops it off to Stockton. Stockton loops through the paint. Great first step. And Stockton will take it in for the field goal.
Well, his defender fell down. It couldn't leave the basket to pick him up.
Krishan Dixon up to Yor. Eyed the three for a moment. Michael Yor goes left side to Aza Williams. Williams moves it across. Belich going to fire. Three-point shot goes long. Stockton with the rebound. So the Warriors up by 2, 6-4. Stockton puts on the brakes, gets it off there to Lustig. Lustig with the left hand, steps back. Lustig goes with his left hand this time, swaps hand, shot blocked for Krishan Dixon. What a read by Krishan. He comes across with a right hand, swats it away. Montana Tech gets the ball back. Digs into the offensive side. Krishan Dixon out to Hayden Deacons. Deacons through the key, attacks with the left hand, it rims out. Boy, he doesn't miss many of those. He shoots 67%. Great bounce pass to Hamilton, and Hamilton finishes.
Yeah, Tech a little weak on transition defense. Got to get back.
LC State leading 8-4. About 3 minutes gone here in this first half. Again, thanks for joining us here on Digger Vision. Aza Williams to Michael Yor. Yor's going to fire. Back of the rim, no good. Montana Tech 0-for-2 from downtown currently. Brown the other way. Diggs shooting 25% from the floor. Brown to Stockton. On the other side, LC at 75%. Stockton rolls it into Hamilton, 12 feet away. Hamilton looking to back it up. Bodies up Michael Yor. Hamilton tries to step through. Good defense by Yor. Shot clock down to 8. They feed it inside to Hamilton. Hamilton turns. Michael Yor all over him. Great defense. Shot no good. Great play by Michael Yor in the paint. Back the other way, Aza Williams, coast to coast. Floater from 6 is up and in. Aza Williams puts in the floater. Tech within 2. LC up 8-6. Stockton down the floor. Top of the horn. Stockton rifles it through the middle and it's taken away. Deacons down the floor. He'll feed it off to Krishan. Back to Aza. Three ball, no good. As Krishan Dixon tries to track it down.
Somebody got a T.
Okay.
Aza Williams get a T for.
Yep, Aza Williams going to be called with the technical.
For a flop.
Okay. So Aza Williams called with the technical. I did not see it. Davian Brown will go to the line and shoot two here for the Warriors. Well,
I saw him go down, but I couldn't believe they called a flop on him, which he did. That's what happens.
So Brown shoots the technical. As he is unable to get it to go down. Or does
no,
get it,
it went
in. Yeah, I thought so. They didn't put it on the board. I'm like, wait a second.
You're going to have to get over there on the scorekeepers. Got to keep up.
LC leading 9-6. About 4 minutes gone here in the ball game. Warriors get the ball as well. Here comes Stockton into the offensive side, drifting to his right. Montana Tech, couple substitutions. We'll talk about those in a minute. Brown going left. He drives, and he will be fouled. Deacons got him with the body. Aiden Deacons will pick up his first personal foul. Cam Lawrence on the floor for Montana Tech, as is Keely Bake. On the other side, Quentin Rayner checks in. They'll feed it underneath to Hamilton. Nice bounce pass, nice finish by Hamilton. He has back-to-back field goals. 4 points for Hamilton, and the Warriors up 11-6. Cam Lawrence through the paint, puts up the floater with the right hand. I think he was surprised he had as much space as he had.
Yeah, he was checking it out, but smart. Set it up.
Warriors lead by three as they come into the offensive side. Stockton lost it off his hip, able to get it back. Left hand, he drives into the key. All the way to the left side, bounce pass to the wing. Little head fake out there by Bradley. Step back, three ball is on the way and good. Big time shot, Jaden Bradley. Bradley has 7 points right now. He's 3 of 3 from the floor, including that one from downtown. LC State shooting 71% here in the first half. Montana Tech at 37%. Inside it goes to Deacons. Deacons steps through, goes up with the left hand. It rattles out. Defensive rebound by Brown. Brown pushing the pace the other way. He's going to fire the step back three, and he gets it. Davian Brown knocks down the three. He has 4 points on the day. And the Warriors go up 17-8. Warriors shooting 75% here in the first half. Lawrence, right side, Belich. Brown on him defensively. Steps through, Belich fires from the elbow. That one comes up short. Warriors get the rebound. Kelsey drops it off to Bradley. He'll move it up top to Brown. Brown looking to his right, checks it back left side as he goes to Rayner. Rayner to Bradley. Bradley, into the loose double team. Bradley trying to find somewhere to go. Pump fake once, fights his way to the rack. Shot no good. Rebound controlled by Stockton in traffic. He'll move it up top to Brown. 3-point shot wide left. And here we go the other way. Montana Tech with a rebound. 3-point shot, Belich on the way, and it's good. Boy, Tech needed that. Belich knocks down the three.
They're a little bit cold right now, but it's early.
LC into the offensive side. 13:40 left to play here in the first half. The Warriors lead by 6. Rayner here on the near side feeds it in the block to Hamilton. Hamilton with the left hand spins, puts it up too far, and Tech with a rebound the other way. Here we come into the offensive side. Diggs with it. Keely Bake. Bake moves left side. Now it comes up top to Michael Uhr. He's going to fire. Mike, no good. Rebound Stockton in traffic.
He's had two good looks, just a little long on both of them.
Tech 1 of 5 from the 3-point line. Warriors down to the bottom right side is Bradley. Bradley with the left hand, bounce pass rolls into Hamilton. Hamilton fakes the pass. He's going to fight his way to the rack. He turns, goes up with the left hand and gets it. Alton Hamilton has 6 points for the Warriors. And they stretch their lead back out to 8. The Warriors have led by as much as 9 here in the first half. Deacons to Bake. Bake comes back up top. He'll move it around the arc right side. Deacons, 3-point shot is money.
Yeah, they didn't guard him because he doesn't shoot him.
He does not much. He shoots 26% from the arc, and he made that one look pretty easy.
He made that look good.
12:30 left to play here in the first half. Warriors leading 19-14. LC with it. Pass here on the near side. Rainer, three ball, looks good. Hits the front of the iron, no good. Tech the other way. Warriors leading 19-14 with 12:17 left to play here in the first half. Montana Tech with it, right wing. Cam Lawrence up top to Belich. Belich drives down the right side of the paint. Pump fake once. Leaner goes up. He gets it. Belich gets the leaner going to his left. He has 5 points, and the Warriors lead is three.
Belich, size advantage, took advantage.
Stockton to Rainer. Rainer far left corner. He dribbles out to the wing, now up toward the top. Rainer goes too far out in front of Brown, and the turnover will go to Tech. Turnover number two for Lewis Clark State College, and we have a timeout on the floor. 11:48 left to play here in the first half. The Warriors up by three. We're back here to the Hyper, ladies and gentlemen, after this 1 minute timeout.
It's more of a business anymore than it is riding. I'm booking, you know, travel, I'm booking athletes, large contracts, insurance, all kinds of different things. Ryan Nielsen, it doesn't get any better. I'm traveling busy all the time, and he'll help with all kinds of different things, from being in touch with my accountant to help finance some of the stuff that I need to get everything taken care of. The relationship there is, it's absolutely amazing.
First, Montana Bank. Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Hey, we're back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech. Second round of the NAIA National Tournament as the Warriors lead by three, 19-16 over Montana Tech. Into the offensive zone, Montana Tech into the ball game is Afanye Okeke. He'll get it off to Cam Lawrence. Lawrence down the right side of the paint, puts on the brakes, moves it out on the right edge to Krishan Dixon. Across to Aza Williams. Williams switch dribble through the lane. Aza attacks. He gets it in the foul.
There were three defenders down there. I can't believe somebody didn't try to draw a charge on him because he was going as hard as you can go. That's a great play by Aza.
So Aza will go to the line and shoot one. He's a 72% free throw shooter. A chance at a three-point play for Aza and a chance to tie us up. LC had the first real run here in the first half. They went up by nine, and Montana Tech has reeled them in. Aza will try and give the Digs the lead, and his free throw is no good. Montana Tech 2-3 from the foul line here in the first half. Warriors lead by one. Far left side, comes up top to Rainer. Rainer fires, long range three, no good. Okeke goes high, he elevates for the rebound. Tech the other way, Keely Bake. Around a screen up top, passes back to his right side, Williams. Aza has it into the paint, feeds it to Okeke, ball fake. Okeke reverses it, Okeke rolls it in.
Good body control, took his time, got the job done. Good run by Tech.
Warriors far right wing, the Digs up by one. Inside is Peoples. Peoples had a great day yesterday. They'll move it out on the left side to Rainer. Also out on the floor is Gordon Boykins for the Warriors. Peoples gets it down to the bottom left corner. Bodied up by Okeke. And it's good. So Anthony Peoples Jr. will be called to the offensive as Ifeanyi Okeke absorbed the first one and went sliding across the floor for the second.
No question on that call. Yeah.
10:35 left to play here in this first half. Montana Tech by one. As across the timeline, Dixon drifting left, hands it off to Lawrence, now up top to Williams. Okeke comes to set a screen. Williams, bounce pass, Okeke to the rack. Wonderful bounce pass, easy two for Okeke.
Okeke with great athleticism around the rim.
3-point lead for the Digs. Warriors, Boykins, Rainer, now left side, Stockton. Stockton outside the arc, he's gonna drive to the baseline, double team, Stockton comes out. He's gonna lose it, we're gonna get a whistle and a foul, and Okeke's gonna get it. All the way down on the baseline, I had no vision on it at all.
I didn't either. Lewis Clark guy had me blocked out totally.
3-point lead for the Digs. Peoples will check out. Back in is Lustig for the Warriors. And the pass comes in to Lustig on the inbound. He's in the key. Pump fake once. Spins to his right. Puts up the shot. Hits the iron and rattles in.
I really like the way this kid plays. Number one, I like how he plays.
Real calm, good demeanor. OKK into the foul line. Pulls up jumper, no good. Rebound controlled by Stockton back the other way. Chance for the Warriors to grab the lead. Driving through the paint, Lustig, double team, moves it up top to Rayner. Rayner to Stockton in the bottom left corner. Baseline runner, ball stripped away. Warriors get it as Lustig comes out with it. Back to Stockton. Tech leading 22-21. 9:27 left to play in the first half. Into the paint, comes up to Stockton. Open three, Stockton drops it.
Amazing, every time I watch him, he, just like his father, shoots identical.
2-point lead for the Warriors. As driving into the paints, Krishan Dixon, nice take by Krishan. Leans into the defender, was trying to get the whistle as well. Rolls it in for two and we're tied at 24. Lustig gets it out to Rayner. OKK went to the ground hard. 3-point shot, Stockton, he gets another one.
Well, why wouldn't he? Nobody's guarding him.
Stockton back-to-back threes. And the Warriors go up by three.
Got to make an adjustment there. They've got to get out on him.
Warriors shooting 59% from the floor, 57% from the three-point line. Tech is at 52%. Aza Williams from downtown, wide right. Stockton with a rebound.
A little too deep. I don't think Coach Hyatt likes that shot.
8:30 left to play here in the first half. Warriors by three. Rayner's going to throw it up from way downtown, and he knocks it in. So Rayner gets his first basket. The Warriors are raining right now from downtown. They're 5 of 8. They're shooting 63% from the three-point line. Aza Williams, everybody sags off him, and he knocks it down.
Nobody seems to want to guard the shooters here tonight.
Warriors lead by four. He was double-teamed, and then all of a sudden he wasn't teamed at all.
Both defenders went with the roll, man.
7:50 left to play here in the first half. Good pass out to Rayner. Rayner from downtown. First miss from the arc in a while. Tech down the floor. Aza Williams. Aza goes up, lays it in. Good outlets. Montana Tech within two. Warriors leading 30-28. 7:30 left to play here in this first half. Second round of the NAIA National Tournament. Rayner drives into the foul line, steps back, moves it left side to Stockton. Stockton with a right hand. Whistle and a foul on the other side of the floor, and that one is going to go against Krishan, I believe. Both teams going to do a little mass substitution here.
Now, if anything will have effect on this, it's the mass substitution they're doing because these guys have nine guys. I don't know if all nine are playing or not. You got the
They did yesterday.
There.
Yep. They did yesterday,
but
so we'll see.
That's wear and tear on you.
Well, we have a timeout on the floor, so let's take one. The Warriors lead by two. We're back here to the Hyper after this 1 minute timeout.
Hudson, your new man cave is sweet.
Come watch the game.
Dude, they're gonna score.
Man cave, lady lounges, whatever you call them, Steele's Furniture has exactly what you need to make your room come to life. Shop our man cave showroom today for ideas to upgrade your bar set, fireplace, TV, recliner, furniture set, and refrigerator. Steele's Furniture, making man caves happen for 87 years.
Hey, welcome back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech. Second round of the NAIA National Tournament here on Digger Vision. As we get ready to roll here after the timeout, Hamilton is on the bench for LC, getting checked out by the physician, or by the trainer, I guess I should say. So we'll see if he is able to get back out on the floor here. Pass down to the bottom right side to Brown. Brown in the corner, drives into the paint, puts on the brakes 8 feet away, moves it across left side to Lustig. Lustig baseline reverse, gets it up and in.
No rotation defensively. Great job by Lustig.
4-point lead for the Warriors. They led by as much as nine. Montana Tech has had a 3-point lead. And Montana Tech with a basketball. Up top, dribbling left. Hand off to Williams. Deacons drops to the baseline. Williams drives, puts up the floater from five, too hard. And on the rebound, we're going to get a whistle and a foul.
Yeah, LC underneath. Yep.
As Lustig will pick up the personal. He was tasked with trying to keep Deacons out of there. And
good luck.
Good luck. Yeah. 6:48 left to play in the first half. Looking to get the ball in on the baseline. Krishan Dixon. Michael York gets it. Hands it off to Krishan. Right elbow. Krishan feeds it into Mike. Michael York spins to his left. Ball stripped away from him. He's able to get it back under control. Dives for it. It's loose on the ground. Good job, Warriors, the other way. Great pass down the floor to Brown. And a travel call on Brown.
I disagree with the call.
Brown called with the walk. Basket is no good. And it will go to Montana Tech. So the digs down the floor. Warriors leading 32-28. And up top with it, Hayden Deacons. Deacons feeds it into the left elbow. Belich has it. Belich up top to Michael Uhr. Michael Uhr feeds it back to Belly. He's going to fire. It's going to go wide left. That one out of play. And it will go to Lewis Clark State. Tech shooting 25% from the three-point line here in the first half. On the other side, Lewis Clark State shooting 56% from the arc. Warriors by four. Little chess match here in the opening half. Pass out on the right wing, Rayner. Rayner feeds it inside to Peoples. Peoples back out to Rayner. And we're going to get a whistle and a foul the other way. Michael Uhr is going to be called with a hold as he and Peoples were bodied up. So Mike's first. 5:54 left to play in the first half. We don't have much in the way of fouls right now. Five team fouls for Tech, four for LC. But I still feel like fouls are going to be an issue as this one goes.
Yeah, they'll get into seven here pretty shortly.
The inbound gets knocked out of play by Deacons. Warriors will keep it on their offensive side. Hamilton checks back in. Peoples goes to the bench. We were kind of worried, honestly, for Hamilton. He was over on the bench. The trainer was giving him a pretty good once-over, so it's good to see him back on the floor. You pull him out of the equation, that changes a lot.
Oh, absolutely. That guy's a player.
Inbound to Lustig. Lustig, right wing. Feeds it out to Brown. Inside to Hamilton. Knocked away. And that will remain LC basketball with 11 on the shot clock.
Yeah, that's good. Uhr gets in trouble when he bodies up. And that time he gave himself space, got a hand on the ball.
5:45 left to play here in the first half. Lustig gets it. He'll drive through the lane. Lustig's shot partially tips, and they will say it is good. John Lustig, 6 points, three field goals, all attacking the basket. So a six-point lead for the Warriors. LC, high percentage shots so far in the first half. They're at 62%, and they have not forced many shots at all here in the first half. Cam Lawrence, top of the horn, down the right side of the paint, kicks it out on the edge. Three-point shot is on the way and good for Hayden Deacons.
Well, they watch film. They're leaving him alone. They aren't anymore, by the way.
He's been sandbagging his three-point shot until he got to the NAIA tournament.
Well, you know, you can't leave a guy all alone. He's got to shoot that. Yeah.
Three-point lead for the Warriors as they come into the offensive side. Around a screen. In the right corner, Lustig fires the three. It rattles in. My goodness, John Lustig. That one hit the iron, jumped straight in the air, and fell through. Montana Tech with it. Michael Uhr, top of the horn, moves it out right side. Cam Lawrence. Lawrence with the left hand. Drives into the paint. Lawrence attacks. Floater too hard. Defensive rebound by Hamilton. Warriors lead by six. They're controlling the flow right now. Brown to the baseline. Krishan Dixon leaning on him. Shot gets pushed out of bounds. Tech basketball.
Great defense.
My goodness. Brown actually had him by a half step to the baseline, and then Krishan just got there, and what a tremendous job by Krishan. 4:28 left to play here in the first half. The Warriors by six. We have a timeout on the floor, so we'll take one. We're back here after this one-minute timeout.
We really wanted to expand our menu, really wanted to expand our clientele, offer the full bar, offer the grill and pub menu. I think everybody at First Montana did a really good job just walking us through it and explaining everything. Ryan really helps us by asking us personal questions. It makes a personal investment in what we're doing here. I think that matters more than just about anything, really. The personal relationship that you have and the personal attention that you get.
First Montana Bank. Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
I think there's more than one thing that makes Montana Tech unique.
I think it's incredible. It's special.
I've always kind of thrived off the adventure side of things and the unknown. There's no place I'd rather be going to school.
Montana Tech has provided me more than I ever could have expected.
Montana Tech made me a trailblazer.
Montana Tech made me a healer.
Montana Tech is my solution.
Be the solution. Visit Montana Tech today.
Hey, we're back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech, the second round of the NAIA National Tournament, as the Warriors of Lewis Clark State College leading Montana Tech 37-31. LC State received an at-large bid. They finished 19-3 in the Cascade Conference and got to the semifinals of the Cascade Tournament as well. Montana Tech, Frontier Conference champions, driving down the right side, pass out to Deacons. We're going to get a block call on Brown. So Brown will pick up the block as Cam Lawrence down the right side of the paint. 4:14 left to play here in the first half. OKK and Aza Williams back in. Michael Yore and also Hayden Deacons will check out.
Yeah, I think LC's having problems with OKK. I think he did some good things when he was in there the first time.
Diggs will lob it out to Aza Williams. Williams down in the corner it goes. Keeley Bake up top to OKK, back to Williams. Williams into OKK. OKK to the rack, it rims in, and the basket counts.
That's where he belongs, around the basket, really effective.
Ifanye OKK, 6 points. He will shoot one. OKK, a very good free throw shooter as well. Montana Tech within four, trying to make it a one possession ball game here. Personal foul charge to Lustig, his second. Lustig did get in foul trouble last night as well. And at the foul line, OKK. OKK's free throw attempt is up and good. 3-point play for OKK. He has 7. And Montana Tech trims the lead to 3. The Warriors lead 37-34. Warriors shooting 61%. Tech at 51. Brown into Hamilton. Hamilton bodied up by OKK. Hamilton in the paint, moves it up to Stockton, who bobbled it for a minute. Stockton down the left side of the paint, comes up top to Boykins. Boykins steps back as it comes up into the hands of Bradley. Bradley fires, no good. Rebound controlled by Aza Williams.
Good defensive possession by Tech.
Aza Williams into the offensive side. OKK moves it across to Lawrence, left wing. Lawrence steps around a screen, spins to his right, double team up top. OKK fires the three, no good. Defensive rebound by Bradley. Bradley to Stockton. 3:18 left to play in the first half. Warriors up 37-34. Stockton with the ball across midcourt. Stockton with the left hand kicks it out to Bradley. Bradley now looking to his right, moves it across to Brown. Brown on the inside to Hamilton. OKK tried to reach around. We're going to get a whistle and a foul. And it's going to be an offensive call. That's going to go. It looks as though Bradley, I believe, and that's the case. So Jaden Bradley's going to pick up the offensive foul. Was it a hook?
Yeah.
Okay.
It was.
3-point lead for the Warriors. Montana Tech with a basketball. Good feed inside to Lawrence. Pump fake once. Gets the shot up and in. Cam Lawrence. Lawrence with 4 points. Tech within one. Warriors, 3-point shot. Bradley. That one goes long. Tipped out. Rebound by the Warriors. Brown with it. Brown continues to eye the long range three. Bounce pass to Bradley on the baseline. Bradley spins to his right, puts it up and in. Nice take by Bradley.
Definite size advantage. Keeley Bake had to guard him down there on a switch. Just too big.
Jaden Bradley, 9 points in the first half for the Warriors. He has 9. Lustig has 9. And Belich fires and it rattles in. From the foul line, Belly knocks it in. Montana Tech within one. 2:10 left to play in the first half. Stockton moves it up to Bradley. Bradley, little shake and bake. He'll attack, and that one rattles out, but it comes right back to Hamilton. My goodness, Hamilton dribbles out with it to Brown. Left side, Bradley. Bradley fires again, no good. OKK rebound. Down the floor quickly, Keeley Bake. Bake outside the arc. Left hand drives into the high posts. He'll move it across right side to OKK. Tech looking to get the lead here. OKK bodies up. Puts it up off balance. OKK gets it in.
It's playing well.
OKK with 9 points. Montana Tech leads by 1. That's our fifth lead change here of this first half. Tech by one. Bradley moves it out to Boykins. Boykins moves it up to Stockton. Stockton into the high post. Taken away. Now it's loose on the ground. Picked up by Brown. And it's going to be a trip call. Aza Williams is going to get it. That's tremendous effort out there defensively by Caleb Bellich.
Just a bad break.
So Aza Williams will pick up his first personal, or check that second, because he had a technical early. 1:14 left to play here in the first half. Montana Tech by one. The Warriors looking to bring it in. Stockton to Boykins. Boykins attacks, gets the pass and the points.
That's two of those they've given up.
Yep. LC by one, 41-40. Bellich going to fire the three. It's good. Caleb Bellich has 10 points.
About time for him to get on fire. Somebody's got it, and he's doing his job. Okiki's really doing his job.
Bellich, 4 of 7 from the floor here in the first half. Tech by two. Brown moves it around the arc, left side to Boykins. Boykins attacks with the right hand to the rack, puts some air under it, and rolls it in. Boy, he makes a nice cut that time into the key. And the Aza Williams will be pulled out here. 39 seconds remaining in the first half. We're tied up 39 all. It's a short timeout. We'll go ahead and keep it here.
Yeah, I think Aza tweaked his knee on a play, and that's why he got beat on this layup back here. His foot movement was not very good, so he hurt something.
43 all our score. And we have 40 seconds remaining here in the first half. As far as what we're used to, this is a very high-scoring first half for a Montana Tech basketball game.
Well, both teams are attacking the basket so well. Kiki's really done a great job for Tech, and LC's getting to the basket, so they're going to have to make some adjustments defensively, definitely, to start the second half. And I don't look for LC to continue to shoot the threes. The last two or three times that they've got an attempt at it, they weren't successful. So you maybe try not going out and guarding them as hard as you have been.
OKK with it up top, leaves it out to Krishan Dixon, 20 on the shot clock. 25 seconds now remaining in the first half. We're tied up 43 all. We have had four ties to this point. As Bellich makes his way to the basket, and he is hugged all the way into the paint.
Yeah, he was going to be wide open. That's why he got hugged. Made a great cut.
Sam Stockton picks up the infraction, and that'll put Bellich at the line. So he'll shoot the 1-1. Bridger Deedon's going to check in. One of the seniors on this Montana Tech roster. And Bellich at the stripe, one of the other seniors. Of course, Bellich, first team all-conference, was the Frontier Conference MVP a year ago.
First team all-American.
There you go, first team all-American. Destroyed his knee in the first game of the NAIA tournament last year. It was in the first minute of that game. And has just been remarkable getting back. Caleb Bellich, 12 points.
He's had a good first half.
Montana Tech leads 45-43. Bellich is the leading scorer on the floor with 12. And a timeout on the floor with 19 seconds remaining here in this first half as the Warriors will set up a play here to look to send us into halftime.
I'll reword that. He's had a great first half.
Yeah,
not
really
good.
Has.
Great.
Bellich right now, 4 of 7 from the floor, 2 of 4 from downtown, and 2 of 2 from the free throw line. Again, thanks for joining us here as we approach halftime. I do believe Matt Steppen, our illustrious athletic director, will join us at the half. We're going to talk about the Digger auction as the auction coming up on April 13th on this very floor.
See what they got diagrammed.
19 seconds remaining here in the first half. Montana Tech leading 45-43 over the Warriors. And Lewis Clark State College will look to bring it down the floor here. Stockton gets it into Brown. Montana Tech will back out, make him dribble it up the floor here. Cross the timeline with 11 seconds. Brown out near center circle, down to 8 seconds. Brown passes left to Rayner. Rayner, 5 seconds. Back to Brown. Long range three is up and good.
They didn't diagram that. They did not diagram that, but it was Davian Brown knocks down a huge three, and the Warriors lead by one. 46-45 our score. The Warriors of Lewis Clark State up over Montana Tech by one. We have 20 minutes left in regulation. We'll take a break. We're back here after this two-minute timeout.
Now's the time to get into Butte Auto and custom build your own ride just the way you want it. Choose from 9 brands and compare them all at one location. Don't wait. Take advantage of our VIP appointment or stay where you are and shop easily from ButteAuto.com. At Butte Auto, we believe in exceptional service and an easy buying process. Easy buying process. Contact one of our 4 dealerships and custom build your next ride at Butte Auto today.
Trident 5550, the Case IH combination application system solution. A couple of key points for model year 2024 are going to be the addition of 135-foot spray boom for that enhanced productivity, and then AIM Command Flex 2, the ultimate in advanced spray technology, individual on-off nozzle control, a host of other features, making the most of your product application. To learn more, visit your Case IH distributor or caseih.com.
Hey, welcome back here once again as we are at the campus of Montana Tech, the second round of the NAIA National Tournament. There are 32 teams left in play, and by the end of the day, we'll cut it down to 16, and those 16 will meet in Kansas City to find out who will haul home that red banner here in a couple weeks.
Yeah, it's important. You want to haul that home. It's a good one to bring home.
That is a good one to bring home, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's a good one.
Well, I don't know how many Frontier Conference teams have won the national tournament, maybe a handful.
One. Rocky Mountain College in 2009.
And Carroll's played for it, right?
Yep. They have. So, again, thanks for joining us as we make our way through a Saturday afternoon. A one-point lead for Lewis Clark State College. This is not the game I expected in the first 20 minutes. Give me your take.
Well, they're both so smooth offensively that I expected it to be in the 80s, to be quite honest with you. We might get in the hundreds here before the day's over. But both coaches have to make some type of adjustment. I'm going to come out of that locker room, and it's not going to happen, but I'm going to start Okiki. He is really a problem for them, and he's created some real nice situations where he got to the bucket. He doesn't need to shoot a three. If he's all alone, there's a reason he's all alone. It's because he's not good at shooting three. So find a way to attack the basket. I think Tech's got to continue to attack. I don't know how many free throws they shot that half. Not a lot, I don't think.
5 of 6.
Yeah, not enough. Okay. And so I think they've got to attack the basket and continue to do what they're doing. There's not a lot of adjustments here. They're just good shooting going on.
Yeah, truly, that has been the case. I mean, LC State shooting 58% and 50% from the arc. On the other side, Montana Tech 56% from the floor and 36% from the three-point line.
Yeah, so let's get off the three-point line. Let's get to the basket. Let's get the ball into the bigs and see what happens. I think Okiki is a problem for this team.
Okay. Let's talk about look at the four Lewis Clark States in that first half. What do you like that they're getting accomplished?
I like their distribution to the basketball. They are really, truthfully, a methodical offensive team, and every one of their shots are good-looking shots. There's no pressure, no hand in their face. They don't take bad shots, and that's a sign of a great basketball team. I like what they do offensively.
Again, thanks for joining us as we make our way through a Saturday. The Warriors of Lewis Clark State leading Montana Tech 46-45, second round of the NAIA National Tournament, as we are here on Digger Vision. Let's take a quick timeout. We'll come back. We'll give you the individual and the team numbers after this one-minute break.
Branding with a company like Butte Auto that shares our mission of community partnership, making the Butte community a better place to be while being excellent in their field, is a natural partnership that we're excited to be a part of.
Hey, Dave Brennan here with Case IH. One of the new options for model year 2024 is going to be an open spoke gauge wheel. That open spoke gauge wheel is going to be available on all 2000 series planters. That's going to help those growers in adverse conditions, whether muddy or high residue conditions, minimize that plugging in and around that gauge wheel area. For more information on this new offering of open spoke gauge wheels, visit your local Case IH dealer.
Hey, welcome back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech. Hopefully everything going well for you on a Saturday. St. Erho's here as we get ready for St. Patrick's Day tomorrow. Obviously things are going to be a little bit crazy. I do have one. Let me dig out my notes here. We do have a congratulations to put out as Brian Bach, who I do believe still has the all-time scoring record for Montana Tech, single game scoring record. Welcome twins to the family. If not yesterday, then here earlier this week. But Brian Bach and his wife, they have twin sons, Jeremiah Keith Bach and Jalen Samuel Bach. So he and Crystal, congratulations. Hopefully they and the family are good. But Brian Bach, certainly one of our favorites here at Montana Tech with twins.
I got a feeling those two kids are going to be able to shoot the three. Oh, what do you think?
What you think, baby?
Yeah.
Holy moly.
Yeah.
So, Brian, congratulations. And I think that's a name that a lot of our friends down in the Lewiston area will certainly remember as well. I want to say Brian was, I'm going to guess, maybe 08, 09, like 08 through 11 maybe.
Somewhere.
Maybe
there.
A little bit farther advanced than that. But anyway, that's it. Congratulations to Brian and Crystal as they welcome twins to the family.
And congratulations from Coach Thatcher. Don't teach them to dunk. Teach them to shoot.
Hey, again, thanks for joining us here. Second round of the NAIA tournament as we are here in Butte. Let's take a look at the individual numbers. Then we'll go to team numbers here in a moment. Individually, we'll start it off for LC State. Leading scorer right now, a pair of guys with nine. John Lustig has nine. 1 3-pointer, 3 field goals inside. Jaden Bradley also with nine. He has 1 3-pointer, 2 field goals, and 2 of 2 from the foul line. Sam Stockton has 8 points, a pair of threes, back-to-back threes, and a runner in the lane as well for 8 points. Davian Brown has 7, 2 3-pointers, 1 of 2 from the foul line. Alton Hamilton has 6 points, all from point blank. Gordon Boykins has a pair of field goals for 4, and Quentin Rayner has 1 deep ball for 3 points for the Warriors of Lewis Clark State. On that deep ball situation, the Warriors shot 50% from the arc. They were 7 of 14, and that number actually fell as
yes,
we went towards halftime. It was beyond the lights there for a while.
And they were shooting from beyond the lights. Way
no
past
joke.
The NBA arc on some of those.
So otherwise for LC State, 15 total rebounds. They are out-rebounding Montana Tech 15 to 10. They have 3 offensive rebounds. Those have turned into 2 second-chance points right now. And otherwise, Lewiston has 4 turnovers. So the Warriors with 4 turnovers there in that first half. On the other side for Montana Tech, leading scorer on the floor is Caleb Belich. Belly has 2 3-pointers. He's 2 of 2 from the foul line. Couple runners inside. 12 points for Caleb Belich on the day. Ifanye Okeke has 9 points. 4 of his field goals coming from point blank. He's 1 of 1 from the foul line as well. Aza Williams with 8 points right now. Aza is 4 of 7 from the floor. He has a pair of rebounds, couple assists as well. Williams with 8 points. Also with 8 points is Hayden Deacons. Deacons with 8. He has 2 3-pointers. He has 1. He has 1 runner inside as well. 8 points for Deacons. He's 3 of 5 from the floor. He has one steal as well. Also for Montana Tech, Cam Lawrence, a pair of field goals for 4. Krishan Dixon, a field goal for 2. And Michael Yore, 2 of 2 from the foul line. 2 points for Michael Yore. No field goals in the first half.
Yeah, well, again, I'm going back to Michael Yore as the X factor. He's the guy who's got to pick up the score and help out these other guys. I like Velich is feeling it. He's feeling good. He's got to get the ball. I would like to see them use Okiki more on the block, and I'd like to see Velich go down the block. He's not being guarded by somebody who's taller than him, and he can get his shot off down there.
Team number-wise for Montana Tech, they shot 56% from the floor, and that number really started to rise drastically as the back 10 minutes of that first half went on, because they started cold and were able to regain a little bit of ground. 36% from the three-point line, as they are 4 of 11 from downtown. They have 10 rebounds right now, only one of those offensive. They didn't get any points off of that offensive board, and only one turnover for Montana Tech, and that is certainly their MO as we get ready here for the second half.
Well, you just came up with your scouting report. They have got to come up with more offensive boards than one. They've got to get 4, 5, 6 this half to if they want to expand a lead and get a comfortable lead where they can force the other team into some bad shots and into some turnovers.
The Warriors lead by 1, 46-45, a very high-scoring ball game here through the first 20 minutes. We'll take a break. We'll come back. We'll get you ready for the second half, ladies and gentlemen, after this 1 minute timeout.
It's more of a business anymore than it is riding. I'm booking, you know, travel, I'm booking athletes, large contracts, insurance, all kinds of different things. Ryan Nielsen, it doesn't get any better. I'm traveling busy all the time, and he'll help with all kinds of different things, from being in touch with my accountant to help finance some of the stuff that I need to get everything taken care of. The relationship there is, it's absolutely amazing.
First, Montana Bank. Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Hey, we're back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech. The Warriors of Lewis Clark State's an at-large bid out of the Cascade Conference. They finished 19-3 in the Cascade and 23-8 overall, taking on Montana Tech, the Frontier Conference regular season and tournament champions. And they had one loss in conference play, that coming to Providence. Otherwise, the Digs ran the table in the Frontier this year.
They absolutely did, and the best thing happened to them was getting beat at Providence, because that turned their whole season. I'm sure that coach had a lot of words of wisdom to give his players.
Yeah, I know. I know they had a nice, bright, and early 6 a.m. practice that next morning.
That's what they're supposed to have. I like it.
So, again, thanks for joining us here. Second round of the NAIA tournament. The winner of this site, whether it be the Warriors or the Ore Diggers, they will pack it up and head to Kansas City and take on 15 other programs in Kansas City to bring that red banner home. This is the second year in a row that Montana Tech has hosted, and their third year straight that they have made the tournament. As going back 2 years prior to this, they were down to Waxahachie, Texas, and Segu got the win in the first game, lost to Segu in the second game. Last year, they win both of their games here, won one more in Kansas City before falling in the round of 8. And we will see what happens this time around for the Ore Diggers with 20 minutes left in this ball game.
I think the guys built the program here.
A little bit.
Big time, got a great culture. All the players buy in, they handle their roles. You know, the toughest thing to be is a role player. They all handle their roles real well. The guy's a basketball coach.
Boy, I'll tell you, I'm real impressed with the way LC has put things together here in the playoffs. As you know, we saw him real early in the year, and to be completely blunt and honest, like, I wasn't horribly impressed. They fell here to the Digs. I believe they fell to Western as well, if memory serves correct, just off the top of my head.
But, boy, I'll tell you, they are a well-disciplined team right now. They're playing hard. They get after it. And they are they belong in this tournament, flat out.
Oh, absolutely they belong in this tournament, no question about it. And I'll tell you what, that's a heck of a coaching job over there, because Tech beat them up pretty good. Western beat them up pretty good. So they have just – that's what great coaches do. They bring you along when it's important. And you don't like to lose those non-conference games, but they're a learning and an experience thing. And you want to be ready for conference so you can do what these two teams are doing out here tonight.
A one-point lead for the Warriors, 46-45 over Montana Tech. There's not much in the way of foul trouble for Tech. Kershawn Dixon has two personals. On the other side for Lewis Clark State College, Lustig has two and Bradley has two. So if one of those two, especially for the Warriors, if you look at Lustig or Bradley, if one of them picks up a quick third, that could certainly change the dynamic a little bit.
Yeah, that's the key, quick third.
So the Warriors by one, 46-45. Michael Yor, we have Kershawn Dixon. It looks like Hayden Decons, Caleb Belich, and Asa Williams, the starting five on the floor here for the Digs. And Bradley will inbound right in front of us here for the Warriors. He'll look to get it into Stockton at midcourt. So Stockton gets into the backcourt. Our second half is underway. Final game here at the Hyper for the year. Bradley drives to the baseline, turns to his right, bodied up by Decons. Bradley pump fake one, shot blocked, Michael Yor. Here comes Kershawn Dixon the other way. Dixon flows to the left wing, feeds it inside. As it gets down to Belich, Belich fights to the paint. Belich puts it up, partially blocked, whistling a foul.
Right to him. I think that's great. He's got a smaller mismatch, and he's tough down there. They're eventually going to have to double him up and leave somebody wide open for three.
And LC's kind of lucky in that respect. It went to Stockton. I thought Bradley was there, too, and that could have been that quick third on Bradley. But it is Stockton second. And at the line, Belich. He has 12 points on the day. He gets the first point of the second half.
I really like what Tech did. They came right out and got him on the block.
87% free throw shooter, and he makes both of those look awful easy. 14 points for Caleb Belich. Montana Tech leads by one, their fourth lead here of the ball game. Warriors, we have had 8 lead changes. We've been tied 4 times. Hamilton has it in the bottom left corner. Michael Yor, he's going to pick up the foul.
Well, he doesn't need to reach. He's trying to reach to touch the ball. That means he puts his offhand on his hip. That's what he got the call for.
So Yor will pick up his second personal. And we are just underway here in the second half. The Warriors looking to bring it in. Pass comes down to Lustig, bottom left corner. Lustig going to drive baseline. Belich on him. Yor blasts it out of bounds.
That's two from behind blocks. Impressive.
Michael Yor, 2 blocks here in the first minute of the second half. And the Warriors will look to inbound one more time. Warriors looking for somewhere to go with it. Stockton throws it in the corner to Bradley. Bradley has Decons on him defensively. Bradley gets bodied up, pump fake once. Shot goes up and no good. Rebound Asa Williams.
Fourth shot, good defense. Yep.
1 point lead for the Digs. Driving Asa Williams into the double team. Puts it up off balance. Tipped up by Decons, but the Warriors come out with it. Bradley tips it out. Brown down the other way. Bradley in the corner to Lustig. Back to Bradley. A little over a minute gone here in this second half. Warriors with the basketball. Lustig bobbled it for a moment. He's able to get it back before midcourt. Top of the horn. Lustig down the right side. Spins into the paint. Pull up jumper. No good. Rebound tips. Ortigar basketball.
Both teams boxing out real well.
Decons, right wing. Moves it up top to Michael Yor. Yor drives, Yor puts it up. Yor shot no good, but he does draw the foul. So Michael Yor still looking for his first field goal, but he will go to the line and shoot 2. He is 2 of 2 from the foul line. And Yor, as we take a peek here, first free throw attempt rattles out, no good. 90 seconds gone here in this second half. Tech by one. 47-46. Second round of the NAIA National Tournament here on Digger Vision. Michael Yor, the junior out of Idaho. Second is good. Big Mike, 3 points on the day. 2-point lead for the Digs. Brown, great bounce pass to Hamilton. And he'll move it out to Bradley. Boy, that was an easy 2 points if he could just hold on to that basketball. Just couldn't reel it in. Rayner near left wing. He'll lob it inside to Hamilton. Hamilton with the right hand. Bodied up by Ewer. Hamilton kicks it out to Brown. 3-point shot, no good. Big rebound, Deacons. Deacons to Krishan Dixon. Dixon into the offensive zone. Michael Ewer to Williams. Azar around a screen. He steps into the elbow, feeds it to Ewer. Ewer attacks his shot, no good, but he's back to the line. Boy, Michael Ewer just can't buy one right now. But he will go to the stripe and shoot a pair.
Well, that shot, throws your shot off, but I was watching him with the football bags down here, and they were doing the same exact thing. And you got to take that a little serious because this happens. You want to take it, you're down there, you want body to body, you want to be able to score.
Michael Ewer at the line, first is no good. Mike is 3 of 5 from the free throw line. Bradley will come out with his third personal foul, and Lustig will check in. So as we mentioned, those two in a little foul trouble, and that could be an issue. Michael Ewer looks like some blood on his left wrist, possibly. Tech leading by 2. I would like a big round of applause there. You can see Trey Vincent taping up the elbow, or up the wrist, excuse me. And very rarely do we see Trey Vincent do anything here. So I just want to congratulate him for actually working.
He's a family man. You got to leave him alone.
All he does, JT, all Trey Vincent does is steal my coffee every day. That's it.
Well, I know that's something you don't do with you.
No.
You need your coffee.
No. Tech leading 48-46. Second round of the NAIA National Tournament here on Digger Vision. Montana Tech by 2. We have had 8 different lead changes.
So they're taking him out and putting Okiki in to shoot his last free throw.
Yep. So they do. He does get pulled out. And OKK, a very good free throw shooter. And the free throw is good. So OKK gets the free throw. Nope. Let me get my book in order here. I'm going to confuse myself with that one. 3-point lead for the Digs. Brown drives the lane. Brown's shot partially blocked OKK, but OKK is going to be called with a foul. A shove call on Ifeanyi OKK. I have him for 2.
Unless he had his off hand down on his back, that would have been his left hand. I can't see it. I can see maybe getting the body to him.
So Davey and Brown at the line. Been real impressed with his play here this weekend as well. Had a great game yesterday. Knocks down his first free throw attempt. 8 points on the day for Davian. He has 2 three-pointers. He's 2 of 3 from the free throw line. And he will shoot one more. So Brown, chance to bring the Warriors within 1. And Brown does so. So Brown goes 2 of 2. We do not have a field goal yet here in the second half. All our points coming from the free throw line. Tech leading 49-48. Krishan Dixon left to Williams, back to Krishan. Dixon, Aza Williams wants the baseline. Now to Belich, ball fake, drives, spins to his right, trying to find somewhere to go. Pass is tipped and taken away, Rayner. Rayner with the steal, Rayner coast to coast. Doesn't get the basket, but he does get the whistle. Aza Williams gonna pick up the personal. And that will put Rayner at the line. So again, no field goals yet. All the points coming from the foul line. And Quentin Rayner will shoot 2.
Well, to be honest with you, both teams have ramped up the defense. It's much better this half than it was the first half.
Rayner gets the first. The Warriors are perfect from the foul line. 7 of 7 today. Rayner will get the ball for his second. And he makes that one as well. So Rayner with 5 points on the day. And the Warriors go up by 1. That is our 9th lead change here of this ball game. A few short runs, but nothing huge. Montana Tech had 1 decent one early for 9 points. Aza Williams left wing has been quiet here. Feeds it into OKK. Cross court, Deacons. Deacons, double team, spins through the lane, left-handed, Hayden Deacons to the house.
Found space, that's a heck of a move.
Hayden Deacons, 10 points. That's the first basket here of the second half for either team. 3 minutes and 15 seconds in. LC Brown, jump stop, kicks it out to Lustig. Lustig with the left hand into the paint. And he is going to get called to the offensive.
That he is.
Dipped his shoulder. That's a big one. That's his third. So Lustig has three. Bradley has three. And Lustig will come out. And Gordon Boykins will come in his stead.
I really like the coach from Lewis Clark, how he handles his players when they come to the bench. Really good.
1 point lead for Montana Tech, 51-50. Into the offensive side, Krishan to Belich, falling to his right, and he'll be shoved. His shot doesn't go, but he will go to the line. Rayner will pick up the personal.
That's a high basketball IQ right there. He knew he made contact, just made sure he got the shot up.
16-23 left to play here in the ball game. Tech by one. Belich at the stripe, 87% from the foul line. It's pretty solid.
Yeah, every coach will take that.
And that one comes up short. We jinx more people than
no,
we
not
could possibly
we. Don't say we.
Don't we.
Don't say
it's
we.
It's we, pal.
They always make them when I say they will.
Keeley Bake checks into the ball game, into the key. Bake and OKK in the key. Belich seconds. Iron, no good. Belich goes 0-2 from the foul line. Warriors the other way.
Won't see that very often.
No. 51-50. A 1 point lead for the Digs. Warriors with it. Brown outside the arc. Brown, top of the horn. He's going to fire the three. It's on its way and good. Davian Brown.
That guy can shoot from deep.
12 points on the day for Brown. That's the first basket for the Warriors in the second half. Bake moves it out right side to Deacons. Deacons has a lane. Deacons floater is up. No good. Battling for the rebound. Loose on the ground. Deacons gets it. Triple teamed. Deacons back up and in.
That's a competitor when you can get that.
That is outstanding. Deacons ties us up at 53. Bounce pass to Peoples. Peoples bodied up by OKK. Peoples puts it up with the right hand. No good. Out of bounds. Tech basketball. So that will go to the Digs. Cam Lawrence, Michael Yore will check in. Aza Williams and OKK will go out. 15:29 left to play here in the ball game. We're tied up 53 all. We only have three field goals in the last 4.5 minutes. Tech has two inside the arc. The Warriors have one outside the arc. And again, we're tied up 53 all. Bake moves it right side to Deedon. Deedon outside the arc, right wing. Puts on the brakes.
They're confused as to what they're doing offensively. They needed a timeout.
15-15 left to play here in the ball game. We're tied up 53 all. And it's a short timeout. And they will move it to full. So it is a full timeout. So with it, we'll take one as well. Ladies and gentlemen, we're tied up 53 all. We're back here to the campus of Montana Tech after this 1 minute timeout.
Now's the time to get into Butte Auto and custom build your own ride just the way you want it. Choose from 9 brands and compare them all at one location. Don't wait. Take advantage of our VIP appointment or stay where you are and shop easily from ButteAuto.com. At Butte Auto, we believe in exceptional service and an easy buying process. Easy buying process. Contact one of our 4 dealerships and custom build your next ride at Butte Auto today.
Trident 5550, the Case IH combination application system solution. A couple of key points for model year 2024 are going to be the addition of 135-foot spray boom for that enhanced productivity, and then AIM Command Flex 2, the ultimate in advanced spray technology, individual on-off nozzle control, a host of other features, making the most of your product application. To learn more, visit your Case IH distributor or caseih.com.
Back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech. The second round of the NAIA National Tournament here in Butte, Montana. We have a tie ball game, 53 all. Our biggest lead has been 9 points. Montana Tech had that 5 minutes into the ball game. The other way around, LC State had a 9-point lead 5 minutes into the ball game. Montana Tech's only lead was 3 points. And that coming here in the first half of this second half. Pass is tipped. Brown got a hand on it, knocks it out of play.
They're really playing Keeley Bake tough. They know that he can shoot it. He's getting no open looks whatsoever.
Keeley Bake into the offensive side. Behind the back, drifts right. Bake fires. Keeley back of the iron, no good. Defensive rebound, Stockton. Stockton will get the rebound. Into the offensive side come the Warriors. Pass left side, Rayner. Rayner around a screen. Good feed to Peoples. Peoples puts it down once, almost taken away. Rayner, baseline. Shot blocked, Asa Williams. Boy, that was a physical series. And here come the digs. Cam Lawrence into the offensive zone. Asa Williams now to Michael Uhr. Good ball fake. Bounce pass back to Uhr. Uhr to the rack, draws the foul. He got it to Deaton, back to Uhr, and he'll go to the foul line. The personal foul on Peoples, that is his fourth. It is third. So they do take one off, so Peoples gets his third personal, and Michael Uhr back to the foul line. Hits the iron, no good. Montana Tech is 9 of 15 from the free throw line, 60% here in the ball game. I believe they finished 55% in the game yesterday. Your second is good. So Uhr gets one of two. And here come the digs the other way. Uhr with 4 points. He's 4 of 7 from the foul line. Stockton, great pass to Brown. Wrap around to Rayner. Rayner, Boykins, all the way around to Brown for three. Brown shot no good. Deaton with a rebound.
Great ball movement. That is how you play basketball right there.
6 minutes gone here in this second half. Michael Uhr to Deaton. Deaton near side. Keeley Bake with it. Keeley. Junior out of Fairfield, rolls it to Deaton. Deaton switch dribble, turns, scoop shot. It doesn't go, but Deaton's going to go to the foul line. Boy, Tech, the amount of shots they have missed on the foul under the basket tonight has been a whole lot of points.
A bunch. And he's usually really good on that spin move,
yep,
knocking those down.
So Bridger Deaton, the senior out of Missoula at the line. Deaton. Right-handed shot, shooting two. Free throw, wide left, no good. Personal foul is on Peoples. Now he has four. LC is getting into some significant foul trouble here. Peoples has four. Bradley has three. Lustig has three. And Deaton at the line, shooting a second. Front of the rim, no good. Rebound, Brown.
Free throw line is their Achilles heel tonight.
10 of 18 from the free throw line, 55%. Stockton here on the near side, dribbles up toward the top. Good defensive pickup. They move it out to Rayner on the far right wing. Across to Boykins. Boykins drives, floater is up and in. Nice touch by Gordon Boykins.
Quick release, nobody was going to block that.
Warriors by one. That is our 13th lead change. Asa Williams from downtown. That one's short. Stockton picks it up in the corner. Here come the Warriors. They lead by one. Stockton. Loose double team, bounce pass down to Hamilton. Hamilton looking to get it into the paint. Wrap around pass to Boykins.
Great pass.
And Boykins finishes. Tremendous pass that time from Hamilton. And the Warriors go up by three. Cam Lawrence wide left wing toward the top. Switches to his left hand. Double team, jump stop. Floater is up. Floater is in.
Sold the pass and opened it up for him. Nice job.
Cam Lawrence, 6 points. Tech trails by one. They're getting ready to sub in four as basically the starters back in. Asa Williams, the only starter on the floor currently. Brown gets it off to Stockton. Stockton into the paint. Bounce pass to Boykins. Boykins has a hot hand lately, and he gets another one. Boykins has 11.
Good job of Stockton drawing the defense and great out pass.
Warriors lead by four. Montana Tech with it. Asa Williams, top of the horn, around a screen. Drives down the left side of the paint. Puts on the brakes. Spins. Pass is going to be errant, out of bounds. Turnover will go to the Warriors.
Tech's got to slow down a little bit.
Turnover number four on the day for Montana Tech. And Lewis Clark State College leading Montana Tech 60-56.
Isn't this the way these games are supposed to be played?
Yes, indeed. Yeah, there's just no way this thing isn't going to come down to a last possession.
No, it is.
Warriors, Bradley back out on the floor with three personals. Hayden Deacons picks him up defensively. Bradley passes left to Boykins. 12 minutes left to play in the ball game. Boykins inside to Hamilton. Hamilton on the baseline, trying to fight his way into the paint. Moves it out. Rayner, step back, fires, jump shot, rattles out. Tipped, Montana Tech basketball. Krishan Dixon into the offensive side. Dixon spins. Dixon lost the handle, but drew the foul. Got bailed out there as that ball came out, and honestly, the contact might have caused it to come out. Sam Stockton picks up his third personal. So Montana Tech is going to spend some quality time at the free throw line, but they need to take advantage of it here. The Warriors lead by four. Montana Tech is only shooting 55% from the foul line.
Well, this is a good free throw shooter. This guy can knock them down.
Krishan Dixon's first is good. 3 points on the day for Krishan. He'll get the ball for attempt number two. Montana Tech down by three. Dixon, left-handed shot, money. 2 point lead for the Warriors. They have the ball down the floor. LC State leading 60-58. Bradley sends him in motion, moving to his right. Pass comes here on the near side to Rayner. Rayner in the corner to Stockton. Stockton on the wing. Stockton with the right hand. Pass to Hamilton. Didn't see it coming. And the turnover will go to Montana Tech.
He thought he was going to shoot it. Went to rebound. But you got to put a bounce pass on the floor. You can still handle that. You can't handle that direct pass.
Warriors by two. Montana Tech with the ball. Tech shooting 53% from the floor. They're 21-40. Hayden Deacons moves it right side to Belich. Belich, Cam Lawrence. Lawrence outside the arc to OKK. Ball fake. OKK drives into the lane. Good defense. Feeds it inside to Deacons. Deacons fights his way. Left-handed. Front of the rim. No good. Defensive rebound. Brown.
Great look at the bucket.
Brown the other way. Into the paint. Kicks it out on the wing. Rayner for three. It's up and good. Quentin Rayner has 8 points. And the Warriors go up by five. 63-58. Cam Lawrence in the high post, spins to his right, back to his left, nothing hoping. Moves it up, Krishan Dixon. Poke checked away, Belich picks it up. Caleb Belich backs out, goes left side, shot clock at 10. Lawrence to OKK, OKK with a right hand, drives into the paint. Ball comes out of bounds, Tech basketball. Stockton got a piece of it. Aza Williams getting ready to check back in here for the Digs.
Oh, KK had a good angle. I think he should have just taken one more dribble. He should have a little jump hook.
Belich into Aza Williams. Top of the horn, three-point shot, wide left, rebound by the Warriors. Forced to throw it up, shot clock was low. And the Warriors into the offensive zone, leading by five. Brown, they'll spread the floor. We are at the midway point here of this second half. The Warriors lead 63-58. Driving, Bradley. He'll kick it out right side to Rayner. Rayner lobs it down to Bradley. Knocked away. It goes out of bounds. And it will remain Warrior basketball.
Yeah, that pass was never going to get there.
We have a timeout on the floor, ladies and gentlemen. The Warriors of Lewis-Clark State leading Montana Tech 63-58. We'll take a break. We're back here to the Mining City after this one-minute timeout.
Hudson, your new man cave is sweet.
Come watch the game.
Dude, they're gonna score.
Man cave, lady lounges, whatever you call them, Steele's Furniture has exactly what you need to make your room come to life. Shop our man cave showroom today for ideas to upgrade your bar set, fireplace, TV, recliner, furniture set, and refrigerator. Steele's Furniture, making man caves happen for 87 years.
Back here once again, second round of the NAIA National Tournament. The Warriors lead by five. matching their biggest lead here of the second half. They had a 9-point lead in the first half. Warriors into the high post. Rainer, floater from 14, is up and in.
Boy, that's the other one. It feels like if they hit the iron, things have fallen in for them today.
Yeah, it has.
10 points for Rainer. Warriors by 7. Rashawn Dixon, wide left. Step back. Comes up top to Michael Yore. They feed it in. As trying to find an opening is Belich. Double team. Belich, step back. He'll fire the jumper. Comes up short. Rebound tips. LC basketball. LC quickly the other way. That one goes down to Lustig. Lustig out to Bradley. Bradley up top. They'll move it around the arc. Right side to Brown. Brown looking on the interior. Little head fake by Brown. Now he'll get it off to Hamilton. Back to Brown. Baseline take. Brown fights his way to the rack. Draws the foul.
Boy, that was a tremendous turn of momentum by Brown.
Yeah, Tech's got to get something going down here in offense. They got to start attacking the rim with 9 minutes to go. Getting away from here a little bit.
Warriors lead by 7. Davian Brown at the line. LC is a perfect 7 of 7 from the free throw line, and they keep that rolling here. The Warriors are 8 of 8 from the free throw line. Montana Tech is 12 of 20. Brown. Ball for his second attempt. And he knocks it down. So Brown goes 2 of 2 from the line. He has 14 points. And the Warriors lead by 9. Montana Tech the other way. Belich, far right wing, feeds it inside to Deacons. Deacons cross court. Krishan Dixon looking to make his way into the paint. He puts it up with the right hand. It rattles out. Defensive rebound, Bradley.
Nothing is going down for Tech.
Rainer, wide left. Looked at pick and roll, well defended. Passes left side to Brown. Brown outside the arc. He goes into Hamilton. Hamilton, wraparound pass, no one home. He delivered that one earlier. Whoa, they're going to say that is LC basketball.
Must hit a Tech guy on the back side. Couldn't see it from here.
8:32 left to play here in the ball game. The Warriors leading 67-58. Keely Bake will check in. Krishan Dixon will check out. As the Warriors will bring it in. On the baseline, pass comes into Lustig. Lustig out to Brown. Brown in the left corner. Keely Bake on him defensively. Brown. Switch dribble, goes to his left. Brown attacks, passes in the corner. Lustig for 3, no good. Rebound tipped out. Montana Tech gets it, almost bouncing over it. Keely Bake dives for it, and we will get a timeout. Keely Bake will get the timeout. Montana Tech will keep the basketball.
Timeout or foul? He dove on top of Keely Bake. That's a foul.
And they're going to give him the timeout. So the Warriors lead 67-58. Second round of the NAIA National Tournament. As the Warriors have stretched that lead out to 9, matching their biggest lead of the ball game. They led by 9 early in this contest.
Well, Tech has created their own issues here right now. They've missed some tough shots, first of all, and then the free throw line has really been the devastation today. That they could have a little lead here, knock down 70%.
You know what, we started this game talking about nerves and if nerves could be a possibility, and it feels like Tech is now feeling it a little bit on their home floor.
Yeah, well, I'm a coach that's not a believer that this deep in the game, that that's even a focal point. You could be correct, I'm not saying you're not, but you know, this is when winners step up. This is when you get your best going, and we'll see what happens here in the next 8 minutes.
Belich, backdoor pass is booted by Lustig.
Had the back door, good play call out of the timeout.
8:09 left to play here in the ball game. The Warriors lead 67-58. The winner will go to Kansas City. Hand off to Aza Williams, drifting left. Williams wide left, looking on the interior, trying to find somewhere to go. Gets rid of it, up to Belich. Belich cuts through the paint, nice pass to Deacons. He's fouled.
Good cut.
If that's on Peoples, and it's not, they're going to call it on Boykins. Boykins picks up his first. Peoples was there. That would have been his 5th. And again, Montana Tech, if they attack the basket, can park themselves at the free throw line here for the remainder of the game. The next foul is going to be double bonus. Deacon's first is good.
Hayden Deacon's 13 points. Belich will check out. Cam Lawrence will come in. So Deacon's will step to the line for attempt number two here. And his second goes wide right, no good. Rebound by Bradley. So Bradley hauls it in. And down the floor we come. Across the timeline, controlling is Brown. Brown looking right, passes back to his near side and Boykins. Boykins, good head fake up top, across to Bradley. Bradley 5 feet outside the arc, drives, steps through, goes to the rack and gets it.
Great take, never got any help at all.
Bradley has 11 and the Warriors up by 10, their biggest lead of the ball game. Asa Williams passes left to Michael Ure, around the horn, Keely Bake. Bake with a right hand, drives, gets it off to Deacon's. Deacon's gets the floater up and in.
Every time.
Hayden Deacon's 15 points. And the Warriors lead is 8. 7:10 left to play. Boykins, crowd getting loud. Bradley, far right wing. Bradley goes to the baseline, gets it up, shot no good. Asa Williams with the outlet. Here come the digs. Keely Bake drops it off. Lawrence. Lawrence to Asa Williams. Montana Tech. Asa Williams from downtown. No good. Lawrence with a huge rebound. Comes up to Michael Ure. Ure attacks. Floater up and out. On the ground. Out of bounds. Tech ball.
A lot of body contact. This is going to get more physical before it's over.
All of a sudden, the crowd has gotten into this thing here. Montana Tech needing some momentum. They trail by 8 with 6:38 left to play. We had an offensive slugfest in the first half, and now defenses have been a much bigger factor here in the second half.
It's amazing. Only 20 points scored.
Michael Ure, right elbow. Ure fights his way to the rim, puts it up. It won't go. Point blank, can't get it to go, and the Warriors the other way.
Well, Tech can't get a break on those.
6:25 left to play in the ball game. Crowd getting loud on the defensive side. Brown, ball comes away. He gets it on the baseline. Brown attacks, scoop shot, no good. Michael Ure with a rebound. Outlet to Williams. Asa, coast to coast, puts it up, no good. It goes out of bounds, Tech basketball. 6:03 left to play here in the ball game. Warriors lead by 8. And it's incredible. The crowd has finally found their voice here in this ball game, and yep, they have made an impact.
And this is when this Tech team needs it.
Williams will check out. Back in, Krishan Dixon. So Dixon will look to inbound here for the Digs. Bounce pass comes to OKK left side. Out to Dixon. Dixon around a screen. Leaves it for Keely Bake. Well defended. Bake down the right side of the paint. Goes to the rim. Draws the foul. Boy, they're trying to get him open. And LC has done a phenomenal job keeping Keely Bake away from the shot.
Well, you know, because of the presence of their other players, he usually gets some wide open looks. This guy's done his film study to know that Keely Bake is dangerous.
Keely Bake, chance for his first points here today. 5:55 left to play in the ball game. The Warriors by 8. Keely Bake shooting 2. First is on its way and good. Keely Bake knocks down the free throw. The Digs are 14 of 23 from the foul line today. And Bake will get the ball for his second attempt. Keely at the foul line. Shot is on its way and it is good.
That's a guy you always want at the free throw line.
Yes. Tech down by 6. Full court pressure. Crowd is loud. Warriors. Brown across midcourt. 5:45 left to play in the ball game. Brown. Boy, this place is just loud. Brown throws it right side to Stockton. Stockton outside the arc. Moves it up top. They'll move it here on the near side. Bradley. Bradley going to be fouled as Cam Lawrence going to be picking up.
No big deal. They got to get that thing close to 7 anyway in case they don't have a, they have to foul at the end.
5:33 left to play here in this ball game. A 6-point lead for the Warriors.
Pass to Hamilton. Hamilton hands it off to Rayner. Rayner to Stockton. Stockton, top of the horn. Bounce pass goes into Hamilton. Hamilton fights his way into the paint. Turns to his right. Hamilton shot no good. Fouled as Okeke got him around the waist. Okeke pleading his case, but we had a great angle. He gave him a bear hug. Team foul number 6 on Montana Tech, so Hamilton at the line.
If you can hold him to 1 out of 2 every trip down the floor, you can climb back in this pretty easily.
Alton Hamilton, first free throw is good.
How good is that kid?
7 points for the freshman. He was the Cascade Conference Freshman of the Year. His second is good. 8 points for Alton Hamilton. The Warriors lead by 8, 71-63. Montana Tech into the offensive side. Hand off Cam Lawrence. Lawrence looking right, passes that way to Belich. Now in the corner, it goes to Keely Bake. Bake gonna drive into the key, kicks it out on the edge. Dixon weaves his way through traffic, fires from 7, no good. Collision, LC basketball, 5 minutes left to play. Warriors lead by 8. Rayner now running the point for a moment. Left side to Brown. Brown puts the ball down. Keely Bake on him defensively. Passes right to Rayner. Shot clock down to 10. Stockton comes up to set a screen. Rayner fires from downtown. Front of the rim, no good. Offensive rebound, Stockton. They get a fresh shot clock. Pass in the corner to Brown. Almost knocked away. Great play by Brown to keep that alive. Hamilton shot blocked by OKK. Tech needing points. Rashawn Dixon into the paint, spins to his right, brings Stockton off his feet. Shot no good, no foul, LC basketball. So here comes Stockton, slowly into the offensive zone, Bradley.
No reason to be in a hurry.
8-point lead for the Warriors. As Bradley, moving left, passes that way. Hand off to Stockton. Stockton up top, moves it across to Rayner. Rayner to Bradley. Bradley, double team. Ball goes out of bounds. LC basketball. So that goes out of bounds. Warriors, they say, will have the basketball. And we're going to get a timeout on the floor. 3:51 left to play in the ball game. The Warriors lead by 8. We'll take a break. We're back here to the Hyper after this 1 minute timeout.
It's more of a business anymore than it is riding. I'm booking, you know, travel, I'm booking athletes, large contracts, insurance, all kinds of different things. Ryan Nielsen, it doesn't get any better. I'm traveling busy all the time and he'll help with all kinds of different things from being in touch with my accountant to help finance some of the stuff that I need to get everything taken care of. The relationship there is, it's absolutely amazing.
First, Montana Bank. Montana's bank since 1913. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
3:51 left to play here in regulation. The Warriors out of Lewis Clark State College leading Montana Tech 71-63. Stockton will look to inbound on the baseline. 5 seconds on the shot clock. The inbound to Rayner. Rayner turns, fires, and gets it. That's a big-time shot.
Rayner has played outstanding this half.
A dozen for Rayner in the ball game. Aza Williams spins in traffic, moves it around left side to Belich. Belich around a screen. Into the paint. Pump fake once. Belich out on the edge. Decons. Decons into the key. He'll turn as his defender fell. Tipped in the air. LC basketball. Bradley came away with it. Big time play by Bradley. He was the defender who fell. He was able to get up and get that rebound. Bradley gets it off to Boykins. Boykins stops, moves it out to Rayner. 3:10 left to play here in this ball game. Warriors lead by 10. It is their biggest lead of the ball game. Rayner attacks to the baseline. Floater is up, off the glass, no good. Tipped out, Decons. Decons across midcourt. almost stripped away from him. He goes to Bake. Bake back to Asa Williams. Asa fires. It's up and good. Asa Williams knocks it home. His first points of the second half. Tech cuts the lead to 7. 2:40 left to play. Boykins, right wing. He'll drift out. They're going to burn some clock. Boykins calls for help, goes to Rayner. Rayner into Hamilton. Hamilton falls. Ball taken away. Keely Bake, ball taken away for him. And he's troubling, and Stockton comes out with it. Stockton will get the easy layup. Back-to-back turnovers.
Big play.
And the Warriors pull that lead out to 9. That's amazing that that could have been down to 5 or even 4, and instead it stretches back out to a 9-point lead.
It just, it's like Tech didn't get a break this second half. A lot of shots rimmed out. Can't make enough free throws. And then you get 2 turnovers like that. I'll tell you, LC has really played excellent. They've played hard. They're playing great defense. It's good. They've made their runs. They've held. That's a big shot by Asa Gray to even think that they'd be in the game. If he doesn't make that, this thing's probably over.
Yeah, Asa Williams with his first basket here of the second half. He knocked down a 3-pointer. He had 8 points in the first half and has really not shot the ball a whole lot here in the second half. Defensively, LC's done a great job on him. The Warriors shooting 49% from the floor as a team. They're still at 48% from the 3-point line. And on the other side for Montana Tech, 43% from the floor, 31% from downtown. Warriors by 9, 75-66.
Well, I'll tell you, this coach from Lewis and Clark deserves a lot of credit for bringing this team this far along. He has really done a great job of coaching as far as I'm concerned.
Montana Tech into the offensive side. Belich going left, stops, comes back to his right side, into the paint, pump fake once, goes up, shot blocked, whistle and a foul. Going to get the whistle here. Boykins was there. And it's going to go on Hamilton. So Hamilton picks up his second personal. Belich at the line.
Tech's going to have to pick up full court.
Trailing by 9 with 2 minutes left. Belich knocks down the first. 15 points for Caleb Belich. And he'll get ready for attempt number 2. So Belich, second is on its way and good. So Belich goes 2 of 2. Belich has 16 points. He doesn't have a field goal here in the second half, only free throws. Rayner moves it off to Stockton. Stockton across to Bradley. Bradley gets it into the offensive zone. Bradley double team, trap coming, moves it across to Stockton. Stockton out to Rayner. Rayner burning clock, shot clock now down to 10. Rayner gets around Asa Williams. Asa tried to slap it away, and he's going to pick up the personal.
Yeah, that's a good foul. I think Rayner was going to create something there. He's forcing the one-on-one.
Asa will pick up his 4th personal, and at the line is Rayner. Quentin Rayner will go to the line. He's 2 of 2 from the free throw line today. And it looks like
Blood.
Yep. Hamilton is going to be checked out by the trainer on the Lewis Clark State side.
Bleeding from the chin, he must have taken a good one.
Warriors leading 75-68. Again, this is the second meeting between these two. They met back on November 17th. Montana Tech got the win 79-55. And I want to look here as the Warriors, they started the season with losses at Arizona and Gonzaga, which obviously you're going to be okay with that. Yeah, you're going to be okay with that. Arizona Christian a loss, Providence and Tech. And they did beat Western. And Rayner at the line. But boy, then, you know, as the season goes on, there's a whole lot of W's and not many L's here, as LC just continually got better and better as the season went on. Rayner, 13 points. His second is back and rim, no good. Rebound by Belich, 1:40 left to play. Belich behind the back to Michael Uhr. Uhr attacks to the rim, and that's in. Counted and the foul for Michael Uhr. That's his first field goal today.
Michael Uhr has 8 points, and he will shoot one. A chance at a three-point play here and make it a five-point lead for the Warriors.
They went for the head fake, gave him free access to the bucket. He finished.
76-70. The Warriors lead by six. And Michael Uhr will shoot a free throw here.
Rebounding just became real important.
Free throw attempt is money. Michael Uhr has 9 points. And full court pressure coming. Bradley in the backcourts. Bradley across midcourt. Bradley, pass comes here on the near side to Rayner. Rayner moves it out right side. Brown looking to coach. Shot clock down to 13. Game clock at a buck 12.
Gotta go.
Brown holding on to it. Shot clock at 8. Brown. And they're going to get a whistle and a foul as Okeke going to be called to the shove.
Bailed them. They were in trouble there.
Okeke picks up his fourth personal. Belich will come in. Okeke will check out. And going to the line is going to be Brown. Davian Brown is 5 of 5 from the free throw line. And shooting his first one here. The Warriors are 12 of 13 from the free throw line. Front half is good. Boy, they have paid some bills from the free throw line today.
That's why they have this little 6-point lead.
Brown getting ready for a second. They're 13 of 14 from the free throw line. Brown's second is up and good. So Brown goes 2 of 2. He has 16 points, and the Warriors lead by 7. 1:09 left to play. Michael Uhr, 3-point shot, wide left, no good. But on the rebound, a whistle and a foul, and that's going to be a shove. Boykin's going to be called with a push. And that's going to put Caleb Belich at the free throw line. So a chance for some points here with the clock stopped.
Coach's getting excited. You don't want to stop that clock.
1:04 left to play here in regulation. Belich first is up and out, no good. My goodness. Free throw line and Montana Tech have not been friends here in the national tournament. 55% yesterday, just a hair over 60% right now.
I don't know how many times I tell you, this game's about rebounding and free throw shooting.
Belich second is good. He gets 1 of 2. Caleb Belich has 17 points. And we have a timeout on the floor. 1:04 left to play here in this ball game. The Warriors lead by 6. With the timeout, we'll take one. We're back here to the campus of Montana Tech after this 1-minute break.
Now's the time to get into Butte Auto and custom build your own ride just the way you want it. Choose from 9 brands and compare them all at one location. Don't wait. Take advantage of our VIP appointment or stay where you are and shop easily from ButteAuto.com. At Butte Auto, we believe in exceptional service and an easy buying process. Easy buying process. Contact one of our 4 dealerships and custom build your next ride at Butte Auto today.
Trident 5550, the Case IH combination application system solution. A couple of key points for model year 2024 are going to be the addition of 135-foot spray boom for that enhanced productivity, and then Aim Command Flex 2, the ultimate in advanced spray technology, individual on-off nozzle control, a host of other features, making the most of your product application. To learn more, visit your Case IH distributor or caseih.com.
.04 left to play in regulation. The Warriors out of Lewis Clark State College, the 11th seed in the Naismith quadrant, are leading Montana Tech, the 3 seed in the quadrant, by 6. In the backcourts, as Rayner gets it, nice feed to Hamilton, and Hamilton slams it home. Good ball movement by the Warriors. Montana Tech down by 8. They'll hand it off to Asa Williams. Williams switch dribble, turns, fires with a 3, no good. Defensive rebound by Hamilton, and he'll be fouled. As Hayden Deacons will pick up the personal, Hamilton will walk the other way and shoot free throws. He's 2 of 2 from the line. Warriors by 8.
Do they got a player there for the next 3 years? This kid's a freshman.
See how
high he got up for that rebound?
Yeah.
he got up.
Yeah, this Warrior team, three seniors. And Hamilton, first is up and good. Boy, the free throw line has just been the tail of this thing right now. Montana Tech has missed 10 free throws. On the other side, the Warriors have missed one. The Warriors are now 16 of 17 from the free throw line. Tech down by 10. Keeley Bake drifting left, hands it off Aza Williams in the corner. Three-point shot, no good. Keeley Bake tips the rebound to himself. Pump fake, moves it out to Deacons. Deacons shot, no good. Rebound knocked away. Michael Yore gets it back to the rack, puts it in. Michael Yore gets the field goal. He has 11. Warriors whistle and a foul as Stockton was fouled by Keeley Bake. So Stockton will go the other way with 28 seconds left.
Truthfully, I don't know who you would foul.
No, right now they've all hit him. Yeah.
Yeah.
And the only one we haven't seen shoot any isn't on the floor. I was going to say is Boykins, but he's on the bench. So Stockton at the line. Stockton's first. Rims out, no good. So Stockton will get ready for attempt number two. 82 to 74. Warriors with the lead. Stockton gets number two through. Sam Stockton with 11 points.
He's really consistent. This guy takes care of the basketball, doesn't make mistakes.
Keeley Bake drives the paint, bounce pass to the corner. Hayden Deacons for three, gets it. Hayden Deacons has 18 points. The inbound to Brown, and we're going to get a whistle and a foul here. Aza Williams is going to foul out. I have Aza with five. So a six-point lead for the Warriors. Aza Williams will foul out. Kershawn Dixon will check in his stead. And at the foul line, going to be Davian Brown. He is 7 of 7 from the free throw line. It's a two-possession ball game. Brown trying to stretch that out to three. Brown, first, good.
Clutch.
They have missed two free throws here in the last 8 minutes. And those are the only two free throws they have missed this entire ball game. Brown's second is up and good. So Brown goes 2 of 2. The lead is back out to 8. Into the offensive side, Kershawn Dixon. Jump stop in the paint, trying to find an opening on the wing. Comes out to Keeley Bake. Bake moving left, stops, fires it on the inside. Tipped and taken away. LC down to Brown. Brown into the paint. He'll move it out on the edge. And the Warriors of Lewis Clark State College are going to advance to Kansas City with an 85-77 win over the Ore Diggers out of Montana Tech. The Warriors, the 11th seed out of the Naismith bracket, will advance with a big win over Hope International, the number 6 seed yesterday, and they'll take down Montana Tech, the number 3 seed here this evening.
Well, I'll tell you what. This team played outstanding here, pretty mistake-free. I don't know what they had for turnovers. Wasn't a ton.
Seven,
that's a great game. And to knock all those free throws down, that was the difference in this game, no question about it. Tech just had a tough day at the free throw line.
85-77, our final. The Warriors get the win. Let's take a quick timeout. We'll come back. We'll give you the numbers, and we will look to make our way through this Saturday night. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back after this one-minute timeout.
Branding with a company like Butte Auto that shares our mission of community partnership, making the Butte community a better place to be while being excellent in their field, is a natural partnership that we're excited to be a part of.
Hey, Dave Brennan here with Case IH. One of the new options for model year 2024 is going to be an open spoke gauge wheel. That open spoke gauge wheel is going to be available on all 2000 series planters. That's going to help those growers in adverse conditions, whether they're muddy or high residue conditions, minimize that plugging in and around that gauge wheel area. For more information on this new offering of open spoke gauge wheels, visit your local Case IH dealer.
Hey, we're back here once again as the Warriors strike and oppose with the bracket board. And Lewis Clark State is off to the round of 16 as they got the win 85-77 over Montana Tech. The Warriors get scoring from seven different players, and six of them were double digits. And the only one that wasn't double digits was John Lustig, who finished with nine.
That's pretty impressive when you only come here with nine players and they all give you a performance and a good, solid performance.
You know, I think you hit it on the head. I mean, that was really, as far as LC earlier, just mistake-free on both sides of the floor. Offensively, they ran their stuff. We didn't see too many shots that were off balance or kind of shots you'd question. But then on the other side, they played great defense. They kept Montana Tech off balance and just put together a really good weekend here to advance to Kansas City.
Well, you know, I don't know if they kept them off balance. Tech had opportunities at the rim, didn't convert. That's the name of this game. You got to do that. And then I go to the other thing. You got to make your free throws if you want to win. It's like golf.
There's free throws in golf.
Tee off for dough and putt, or tee off for show and putt for dough. Free throws are what you do. You putt for dough there.
Let's take a look at the numbers here. We'll start things off as we take a peek here for Lewis Clark State College. Again, there are seven players that scored. They're led by Damian Brown, 18 points on the day for Brown. Three 3-pointers. The rest of his points coming from the foul line here today. Alton Hamilton, the freshman, gets a dozen. Jaden Bradley with 11. Sam Stockton with 11. Gordon Boykins with 11. Quentin Rayner gets 13 points. And John Lustig with 9 points on the day for the Warriors out of Lewis Clark State College. They shot 50% from the floor, 48% from the three-point line, and they were 91% from the free throw line.
That's pretty good shooting.
That's,
you know that,
that's
right?
Pretty good. They were 19 of 21 from the free throw line here today. On the other side for Montana Tech, leading scorer was Hayden Deacons. 18 points for Deacons. He was 7 of 14 from the floor. 6 rebounds as well. Great day for Deacons. 18 points. Caleb Belich gets 17. He was 4 of 8 from the floor. 7 of 10 from the foul line on the day. Also in double digits, Michael Yor gets 11. Aza Williams gets 11. Ifanye Okeke gets 10 points on the day. Cam Lawrence with 6. Krishan Dixon with 4. And Keely Bake with 2 points on the day for the Yor Diggers out of Montana Tech. JT.
Well, this is the way these games are supposed to be played, and they're going to be played like this at the national tournament. And again, I told you there's three teams here that, as far as I'm concerned, could qualify for the national tournament. They could probably play each other 10 times and split. So just the breaks of the game, and LC came in with their A game, and they shot the ball like you're supposed to.
The Yor Diggers will end the campaign at 27-5 this year. The Warriors will advance to Kansas City with a 24-8 record. And certainly from JT and I could not say thank you enough to the seniors here on this Montana Tech team. The work that they have done through their years, just our thanks to the seniors and the great work that they have done for Montana Tech as the Warriors cutting down the nets here in the Hyper.
That's what happens when you win championships. You get to cut down the nets. And real tribute to them. Again, this coach did a heck of a job coaching them through the season. He got them.
They're
when
playing
you're supposed
their best
to get
ball
them.
Right now.
That's what he did.
That's the deal. So the Warriors get the win, 85-77. They go to 24-8. They'll go to Kansas City. Montana Tech will fall here at home, and they'll end their campaign at 27-5. For John Thatcher, I'm Paul Panisco. Thanks for joining us tonight and all season long here on Digger Vision. Until next time, take care.